21-13, 1:39. Geelong defeating North Melbourne, team at 4-64. Your immediate thoughts, Kearns, upon the conclusion of that one? The Cats, they just keep rolling on in 2024.
Very impressive performance from Geelong. Didn't do a lot wrong. I expected more from North Melbourne, to be honest with you. Maybe, you know, a similar scoreline, but I expected more fight and a bit more hunt from North Melbourne consistently. We probably only saw it for 10 minutes of that game. I mean, they held their own reasonably well and held the ball up in the third quarter, but I think it was a disappointing performance from North Melbourne. Leaders let them down. Sheezer was tremendous. Ball use has got a lot of work to do, decision making, but I think they found a couple. I like the defensive combination of Biggie Newen and Combin. I think they can combine very well for a very long time to come, but clinical performance from Geelong.
Certainly was. 21-13, 1:39 to 10-4-64, that final score again for North Melbourne off the back of a 70-point loss last week to Brisbane, a 56-point loss to Carlton. Today's another ugly one when it comes to the scoreboard, and I agree with you, Coons, that the effort just wasn't there for large portions of the game, which allowed Geelong to capitalise. And even though I don't think they were playing it on full cylinders today, Geelong, they were doing enough to get the job done. They started to change a few things in that final term just to test and trial. So they'll take the confidence again of just going through, getting another one under the belt.
Yeah, oh, no doubt. And, I mean, when you talk about Geelong and how set they've been for so many years, to have a couple of guys now being introduced into this side and filling in and doing well, it bodes well for the future of Geelong, and North Melbourne just need to keep piling games into these youngsters.
Now, Reece Hanley is going to be honoured by both teams as they make their way from the ground. After what happened the other week, they're going with the chairlift again. Tom Stewart and Zach Tui have got the honours this time, and it's not a convincing chairlift. It was disappointing the other week. It was a Mitch Duncan that got a bit awkward on Tom Hawkins.
Yeah, this is a bit awkward. It's a real open leg up one, this one.
His backside is underneath his knees. He's sagging all the way down, Reece Hanley.
There's no glute support whatsoever to this, and hopefully he's wearing the budgie smugglers, or else the row 1, 2, 3, and 4 are seeing a lot of Reece Hanley.
Not only that, he'll go out with a groin injury next week. He won't be able to play Brisbane up at the Gabba.
I saw Reece Jr. there.
Final score, 21-13, 1:39, Geelong defeating North Melbourne, 10-4-64. We can start to work our way through the awards from this afternoon's game. Our call team dressed thanks to Ringers Western, whether it's the paddock or the pub or even, what did you call it before, Cooney's?
Club Cooney.
Club Cooney. You can wear Ringers Western there as well.
Am I on the guest list?
Has the kit to keep you warm this winter.
Only if you got your Ringers Western on, JK. Best kit in the business, bar none.
Unmissable moment from this afternoon for Drinkwise. Choose to drink wise. You won't miss a moment if you drink wise.
I reckon it's Maxie Holmes' two goals that he kicked. They were sensational. One from outside 50 and one from a tight spot snap. Same end. So he had a pretty good game. Actually, we'll feature in the votes as well, but that was an unmissable moment or two from him.
The forever young player of the day for Tobin Brothers. Tobin Brothers Funerals, celebrating lives. Who was a player over 30 today, Coons? Stood out.
Let's go with the milestone man in Reece Hanley. He was terrific today. 7 score involvements, 12 disposals, mountain of hitouts as well. I thought he covered the ground pretty well in his 200th.
Tobin Brothers Funerals, celebrating lives every day of the year.
Bendix Brakes, big moment. Put your foot down with confidence. Bendix Brakes.
The big moment was the Geelong goal that they kicked right on quarter time. So momentum swung back North Melbourne's way. They're only a couple down and looked to be in the contest. And I think that broke the spirit of the Kangaroos, and she was all downhill after that.
Who ran the most kilometres? They'll sleep well tonight for the original Mattress Factory. Kick back and relax with an adjustable bed from the Australian design and owned OMF.
No surprises there. Harry Sheezel with 14.5 kilometres. He was terrific all day. Not only mopping up at half back, but also kicking the ball inside 50. His ball use was terrific today. At 38 disposals at 82%.
It's a pretty good day at the office.
Kicked a goal too, Coons. Not sure sausage. If you're aware that he hasn't kicked too many.
Well, how many has he kicked? I mean, he's only been playing for a year and a bit. He must have only kicked half a dozen or even less.
Just his four from 28 games.
Boy, I might put him in the votes just for that.
The coaching move of the day for Henley Holmes, backed by a $7 billion parent company, Henley Holmes, build with confidence.
Well, it was probably resting Tom Hawkins and letting Shannon Neal come in and show that he belongs at the level with three goals.
And the votes for AFL Nation's Player of the Year. Who have you given? 3-2-1 to Coons. Much anticipated.
I don't know. I haven't done it yet.
Oh, all right.
Can you give me 10 seconds just to decide on my one?
Sure
so
thing.
You two just talk amongst each other. I'll tell you that I'm tossing up between giving Harry Sheezel a vote for his 38. Or maybe Bowes, who I thought was really good, played one of his best games with the Cats. And Grian Myers, I thought, in the first half really set it up. So I'm just tossing up between those three. Well, at the moment.
There was that many goals scored today, Coxie. I realised I was giving out the wrong score about halfway through. So not only did I send you up the creek with the wrong stat for Eddie Ford, I think I said it was about 90-odd points of difference when it was about 80-odd points of difference. So sold you and thousands of listeners up the creek. It was 70. Was it 75 points in the end?
Back to the twos for you next week.
I think so, yeah.
You've had a shocker today.
Yep.
75, the final.
Take
margin.
A good hard look at myself.
You do.
This week.
Look in that revision mirror as you wander back up the highway because you won't be moving far from the elements of it.
Oh, I'm not looking.
All right, I'm ready.
Thank you, Chris.
Okay. I'm going to apologise to Harry Sheezel. Sorry, mate, but your team got belted. So we can't give you any votes. And I'm going to apologise to the man who owns a wireless headphone company, and that is Bose, because it was really good today, but I just have a crush on Grian Myers. And he probably had the one vote sewn up even before he ran out there because I love the way that he plays. So we'll give one vote to Grian, and we're going to give two votes to Max Holmes with his 25-goal game, 5 inside 50s, 2 of the best sausies you'll ever see. A couple of clearances to go with that, and he covers the ground well. And we'll give the 3 to Jeremy Cameron, who was pretty good today. 21 disposals, 6 goals. 11 score involvements to go with that. He's a fair player.
3 votes to Jeremy Cameron, 2 to Holmes, and 1 to Grian Myers, the AFL Nation's Player of the Year, as voted by Adam Cooney this afternoon. The MRO incidents for Arnold, Thomas and Becker. Talked to a lawyer today. Nothing really to come out of this match from memory. So yeah. All clear on that front. Injury concern, though, for Colby McKercher, who came from the ground in the first quarter. I've got a feeling it was a marking contest at this broadcast end of the ground with Jeremy Cameron that I think he's come off second best with rib soreness. He was taken to hospital for observation and no further update at the moment from the North Melbourne Footy Club, but that's the only real injury concern to come out of today's game. Our major partner is the TAC. Police can be anywhere, anytime. A message from the TAC. And as we head towards our final break this afternoon for Bendix Brakes, put your foot down with confidence. Bendix Brakes, Reece Stanley and the youngster, the debutant, Connor O'Sullivan. Well, Stanley wanted him to walk from the ground with him, but he's decided to mesh his way back into the pack as the Cats finally depart GMHBA Stadium after celebrating with their many fans that had gathered here today. We look ahead to Richmond and West Coast. This is a curious game.
Scintillating clash coming up here.
Harley Reid, Dusty.
Yeah, well, the new Dusty is Harley Reid after about 7 or 8 Dustin Martin-style fend-offs last week. I expect a few more today. Building nicely into his career is Harley Reid. I think the Eagles will win this one. I think they'll get up for their first dub of 2024, and possibly their only one.
Even though Richmond have been playing all right, they've shown something.
They have in patches, yeah. A lot of injuries, just too many injuries, I think, for the Tigers. And a big trip out west for some of those youngsters might be a bit too much.
And that'll conclude things for round 5 of the AFL after the Cats won by 74 points as the kids invade the turf for the after the siren kick to kick.
Just brushing up on the Northern Volants players for next week.
Yeah, you better.
Go down to the twos.
In fact, no.
Where are we, Tigers?
You can go back to the Eastern Footy League. Northern Footy. Is it in that region?
Yeah, the better one.
Come down to the GDFL if you want, the Geelong Footy League.
You can stay at Club Cooney for the night. What's the accommodation rate there?
Oh, yeah. The pig pen for you, JK.
No, look, I'll take it.
It's insulated.
As we celebrate down in the rooms with the Cats, the winning team celebrating for Tobin Brothers. Tobin Brothers Funerals celebrating lives every day of the year. Almost timed that perfectly. Adam Cooney, thank you very much to you.
Well done, gents. Good luck next week in the twos.
Thank you. Geordie, I think I might join you. I'm Matty Cox. We're taking you over the Nullarbor now for the West Coast Eagles and the Tigers.
That quarter on AFL Nation was for Host Plus. Host Plus has been named Money Magazine's Best Super Fund for 2024. That's a plus. Issued by Host Plus Pty Limited. Check the PDS and TMD at hostplus.com.au.
Subscribe to SEN Sports on YouTube for all the best analysis from SEN's team of experts. Watch your favourite radio shows from inside the studio. Search for SEN and subscribe today.
The traditional owners of the land on which the upcoming match is being played. We would also like to pay our respects to elders past and present.
Up goes Akers! Goal!
The Bob, the dance step, bends it around to full 40, needs the bounce, the Bob, supreme, around the body, you are joking! Just like that!
The 2024 Toyota AFL Premiership season.
Brioli out of the pack. Several one-way cutback. The shimmy of the shake. The shake of the mate. Hit it all. Steps out the body. Two goals in this quarter that has raised the roof. Here's the goal. Got it. Epic finish coming.
Every game, every week.
To Bailey in the pocket and kicks. What a great final goal.
This is the most beautiful game world we're watching. You just can't take your eyes off it.
Majacek in the front. Gardner knocked it away. Nick Dacos, lightning hands. Here's the Ngoi moment. He unloads. Bang! You need your stars. And Collingwood's stars just went and wrenched the cup back.
For 4-20 Pies, Australia's original fan food. Welcome to AFL Nation.
The West, AFL Nation for 4-20 Pies, Australia's original fan food. It's the last game of the round. It is the West Coast Eagles at home taking on Richmond. Eagles 0-4. The Tigers are 1-4 from their five games. Tim Gossage and Paul Hazelby, he's our expert for the match for MEGT. Let MEGT help you build a winning team. And on the boundary line throughout the afternoon, Chris Clifunas will join us for Spitwater Tough and Ready. Earlier today, 75-point win to Geelong. And even bigger news than that, the West Coast Eagles waffle team had their first win in 28 games, beating the reigning premier, East Fremantle, down the road. In that game, Dom Sheed played, Luke True played, Jermaine Jones, Andrew Gaff, also Liam Ryan, and Trey Rusko, the former Magpie, kicked three goals. Paul Hazelby joins us. I wonder if that can just bleed into something this afternoon for the West Coast Eagles as I welcome you here.
Good day, Tim. Yeah, I'm excited, and I think West Coast Eagles fans should be excited too. This is their best chance to get a win this season. And just looking at the Tigers, they got some big names out. Bolt is not there, no Lynch, Hopper, Taranto late out, Prestia, Ross, Gibkus, Grimes. This is a team coming off the back of premierships 3 and 4 years ago. They are cherry ripe to be got today. And I think the West Coast Eagles, if they can bring their brand like they did last week against Sydney, they get a great chance to win. Won't be easy. They're going to have to stop the superstars in Martin and Bolton. But as we sit here right now, Tim, I know you've been excited about it all week. You strongly believe this is the day for West Coast.
2 weeks, actually, Paul. Both teams are on the ground and doing their warm-up for Ream, except nothing less than Australia's best. Ream, don't forget, if you're listening to us and you don't want to watch the TV commentary or hear the TV commentary, SEN Sync. Watch the game while listening to the AFL Nation commentary, available on the SEN app in partnership thanks to Drink Wise. You won't miss a moment if you drink wise. The pre-game show is for Beaumont Tiles. Beaumont's has everyday low prices from $19.95. And before you dig, lodge a free inquiry online. Toss of the coin shortly. So, Paul, I need some unmissable moments, if you can. Thanks to the wonderful team at Drinkwise. You won't miss a moment if you drink wise.
Well, we got so many last week, didn't we? Richmond v St Kilda. So I'm excited and hoping that that will be the case again, that we see some of the gun forwards take control. control. And I think all West Aussies are excited to see Shea Bolton play here in Perth today. He's been outstanding so far. Last week, he did everything. Goals from the pocket, high marks. He's got 11 goals for the year, and he's going to give us some unmissable moments today. Liam Baker, the other West Aussie, back into the side after suspension. He's got 6. So the two between them have 17 goals for the year. And West Coast only have 27 in total. So if the Eagles are to win today, they need to put some work into those two players.
A good crowd building too on a little bit of an overcast day, a little wafting breeze. We'll get to the ground level in a moment. The toss of the coin about to take place thanks to Keno Go. Play Keno Go heads or tails for your chance to double your money every 3 minutes. Download the Keno Go app right now. Heads and tails. Let's go down to Chris Clifunas on the boundary line. Chris, at ground level, what's the vibe?
Good afternoon, boys. A very good vibe. As you said, Goss, pretty much near perfect conditions. A little bit of cloud cover at the moment. The breeze has been coming through slightly, going a bit of an easterly this afternoon. But other than that, it is crisp conditions, perfect for football. The surface is looking pristine. Of course, gather round last week has given them a bit of time to get it cherry ripe. And I think we're in for a good day of footy.
There was some criticism of the aesthetics of the ground. It looks fantastic here today, so they should be very, very happy. All right, toss of the coin. And Liam Duggan is there, Toby Dan-Curvis, and Ross Glendinning, who was, of course, the captain for the very first West Coast Eagles team, which was against Richmond at Subi Oval in the 80s. He's tossed the coin. It's got stuck, and I think they're going to re-toss. I think it landed sideways. Can only happen to Ross Glendinning. Here it is again as a false start toss of the coin. And now Toby Nankervis has done the right thing. Which way has he gone, Paul Hazelby?
He's gone to the Rottnest Island end.
He would do that because 87% of captains who go that way, 78% of those go on to win the game. Keno Go heads or tails. Pre-game show for Beaumont Tiles. Beaumont's have everyday low prices from $19.95. And before you dig, lodge a free inquiry online. I can tell you that the subs are Ryan Marrick and Tyler Sonsi. The change, withered and in for Jamison, and a lot to play. All right, Hayes, give me a final summation of what we're expecting here today on a big day for both football clubs. Richmond have been okay in the first month, but they do have a depleted lineup on West Coast. Produced their best half of footy for a long time against Sydney last week.
They did. They've only got the one win to show for it, the Richmond Tigers. We know the West Coast Eagles yet to register this season. I think through the midfield, if you look at some of the big names out, I reckon it's advantage West Coast. But they need a couple of players to come to the party today. One is Tim Kelly and the other one is Jack Darling in the forward line. Because all the other senior players, led by Duggan, led by McGovern, and Yo through the midfield have been terrific. If they get service from those, the youngsters will jump on, and Harley Reid may be one of those. Ruben Jimby through the midfield as well. So I'm leaning your way. I think having a good look right now at the two teams, I think West Coast have a slight advantage in talent on the park.
All righty, we're about to go. AFL Nation for 4 and 20 pies and TAC. Please can be anywhere, anytime. A message from the TAC. Keep an eye on those matchups, Paul Hazelby. It'll be Nankervis versus Williams. Bounce by umpire foot is perfect. Up and then straight down. Yo, so important. Swats it out. Williams wrapped up in the tackle. No prior. We'll have a secondary ball up inside the centre circle. Dusty Martin. Josh Rotham's got that job. Over the footy, there was Dow. It's a free kick off the ball. It's going Richmond's way and it's going back to Dow.
Looks like Brady Hoff has the matchup on Shea Bolton.
Dow inside 50, coming out hard, and LaFoul has taken an easy mark, and Barris again caught 3 or 4 metres in his wake, and LaFoul is going to line up for goal directly in front.
We saw this a couple of weeks ago with Tom Barras. When he goes with his opponent, he's unstoppable. He's got the speed, he's got the reach, he reads it really well, but when he relies on teammates to drop into that space, he just second guesses, and that's what happened on that occasion. But a great start for young LaFoul.
Goal again. Got it home. 4 games, 4 goals. Great start for the Tigers. It took a minute for Mate Internet and Mobile. $20 off for 5 months with Mate Internet. 1 goal, Richmond, off the boot of LaFoul. Easy as you like. Poor by Tom Barris.
He's been super impressive in the few games that he's played so far. Moves really well. Gets up the ground. Gives a presence. But can also go back closer to go inside the forward 50 and take a mark like that. Just read the ball quicker. Off the mark. That's a disappointing start for the West Coast Eagles. They would have built this game up in the pre-game, and a crucial start here at home they haven't got.
Jeremy Cameron, six straight for Geelong around the grounds. Chemist Warehouse, Geelong by 75 over the hapless North Melbourne. Sunny day, good second bounce by umpire Foot, then Curvis, too big. Pass through the tackle. Yo tries to intercept the hand pass. Dow again busy. They dive on him. He's on the ball. Umpire says, I'll ball it up. It's about 15 metres close to the Eagles' end of the ground, still inside the centre square.
Good by Dow there. He had Tim Kelly to the left and also Elliot Yo, but was able to keep his feet and keep the ball underneath him.
There is Yo. Tries to hack it out of the ground. Harley Reid intercepted by Tim Kelly inside 50. Punched away. Hand pass, Darling. Hand passes away under pressure. McIntosh, Darling does well. Steals it from Rioli. Daniel, kick around the corner. Boston gets across and intercepts the ball 15 metres out from his defensive goal.
It's a good chance, Thompson Doubt. Cement a spot in that midfield with a few injuries.
Short to Miller.
Miller, another West Aussie boy. Out of contract and been playing some pretty good football down back for the Tigers.
Broad. That pocket. Long down interchange wing. Duggan marks it.
He's been in good form, Liam Duggan, the skipper.
And pass on to Rotham, inside 50. Darling was being held. Petrocelli, oh, well done, Broad. Got across and took a very good mark in front of Petrocelli. Richmond try to set things up from the back. There is again Ben Miller, 25 out from his defensive goal.
Got Baker out on the wing, if you can see him. He's just found him.
There's the way the kick will go, and Baker should mark this quite easily. He does, with that left knee heavily strapped on the outside. McIntosh running forward. Richmond have got players streaming back to the goal. McIntosh has a bounce. It's a good hard chase to the top of the square. Witherden's there. Rioli's there. And Rioli, Morris. Oh, he's kicking to the man on the bar. They might get lucky. They'll have another crack at it. Kick around the corner. It is a goal. Shea Bolton. It was good by Witherden, but the ricochet come back to Bolton. And Richmond got him in transition. Two straight 12. Well called by Paul Hazelby. He's the expert for MEGT, Australia's apprenticeship experts. Two straight Richmond. Eagles yet to score. We've gone 4 minutes in the first quarter. And, of course, we are here for the TAC. Police could be anywhere, anytime.
Poor defensive work through the midfield there by West Coast. You can see Baker was free for a long time. And you rarely see a ball travel 50 metres like that without it being intercepted or somebody coming over to contest that. But he's a small player and he took an uncontested mark on the wing. And once they got that, they had the overlap. It was a good work by McIntosh to get the ball forward. Rioli did the great thing on the goal line, took a good contested mark, but then just played on too quickly into the man on the mark. Shea Bolton, he was there to support his little buddy.
Mate, internet mobile, poor start by the Eagles, great start by the Tigers. Williams up over the top. Harley Reid in the middle is being held without the footy, didn't get a free kick, come back to Baker. He goes wide and they set it up half on the far side of the ground. Hand pass. Come back inboard. That gets ignored again. Oh, lace out. Brilliant. And again, Bolton has taken an easy, uncontested mark on the 50. And this is looking very ugly, very early for the West Coast Eagles, Paul Hazelby.
They've come to play. And this guy started well. This would be goal number two. Just kept on leading up. Brady Hoff, the matchup, just lost him in transition. But they'll need to do that today, the Tigers. No tall forwards really down there with Bolter and Lynch out of the side. They're going to have to lower their eyes.
12 goals already. He wants to play on, so he swings around, kicks it long, strong across the face. First miss, Tigers 2-1-13, doing every bit of the attacking. 5.5 gone first quarter for Mate Internet and Mobile. We'll keep an eye on the stats for Hijaz Halal Financial Services. West Coast to bring the ball in. Adam Simpson's got some magnet moving to do early. Duggan gets very close to the man on the mark. Wide kick. Williams goes at it with one hand. Hat forward by Hunt. Down the line. Broad needs a quiet bounce. He wants boundary. He ran it straight over. The intent was certainly, yeah, he didn't disguise that at all well. Coming back to Petrocelli. He's outside five now, so Petrocelli can trip a few metres if he so desires. But the longer he tucks the ball under his arm and looks inboard, the less chance he's got of getting someone free inside 50. So he's just going to kick it up and hope. Waterman and Miller. Big fly up early. Brockman went early. And everyone went up thinking he was going to mark, and he didn't even put his hands up. And standing on the ground was Waterman, and Waterman will go back. And this man that Paul Hazelby thinks could be in for a big game will line up from 35 metres out on a 45-degree angle.
Well, he's been in good form. He's been the Eagles' best forward probably for 2 years now. hasn't probably got full reward on the scoreboard with the six goals coming in. He's had some attempts and he's getting better. He's not overly tall, but as we saw there, can take the big pack mark and normally a reliable shot.
The leading goal kicker for the Eagles this year, six goals. That's a poor kick. Gone to the near side. Seven gone, Eagles on the board, but it's a minor score thanks to Mate Internet and Mobile. Good crowd building. Miller short. Under Jack Williams. Player outside of him. Short. That's the man I'm talking about. He goes out wide. They've lost him. That pocket. Too easy. Chips it up the line. Campbell. Big fly. Foul again. No mark.
Great work by LaFau coming over the top of McGovern. He was free, McGovern. You know how good he is as an intercept marker. Just to bring the ball to ground. Great start to his career.
Curvis, too strong. Jimby through the traffic. Stolen now there by Baker. Quick kick inside 50. McGovern intercepts, goes to Kelly. Richmond getting back in numbers. West Coast very, very slow to get the ball moving. That's off to Richmond, of closing all the outlets. No mark taken. Loose ball at half forward. Again, Baker. Hand pass. That's ambitious. Hand pass back towards Edwards. Going to come again. Brockman gets it back to Waterman. Slung when he tackled. Waterman now kicks into the pocket. Cripps is there. Getting across broad. Does well. Goes after his own ball. Knocks it forward to McIntosh. Outside defensive 50. Chips it back and Miller gets it. And they steady things down here, the Tigers.
Four disposals now for Ben Miller. Leads all comers on the ground. Baker with three.
Ejaz Halal Financial Services stats. Young short. There is Miller again. And another one. Easy as you like. He sets it up from half back. Good kick too. Goes wide. Running all over them on that far side. They come back inboard. Martin. Dusty. Not a great kick. Might get away with it though. Little pitching ball to Bolton. Left it behind. Almost intelligent knock on. Coming back again. They take a long time. There's the square up ball. Rioli. Has he got it? Yes. Rioli. Morris has marked it just above the grass. He's 45 metres out. Will need every bit of 50. He's almost directly in front. And again, lack stuff at half back by West Coast. And the back line under siege. Their midfield getting their pants pulled down.
Great kicking game right now by the Tigers. We know under Damien Hardwick, they like to handball the ball through with that slingshot type of footy. But with Adam Uze in the hot seat, they've changed it up a little bit and they do have that kicking game, particularly if there is a midfield that's not going to man up. That is the West Coast Eagles right now.
Had one kick smothered from 2 metres out earlier in the quarter. Close to the man on the mark again. Might not have the distance, or it has the distance, but he just chipped it and it just got taken to the left. So he has been a little bit off so far with his shots on goal. We've gone 10 minutes. It's 2-1-13. Richmond, 1 point, thanks to Mate Internet and Mobile. And running hot for Ream, Ben Miller. Ream, except nothing less than Australia's best. Ream.
He's improving every week, though, isn't he, Rioli? Some good tackles last week and hit the scoreboard with two goals.
Nice kick. Barris, big fly up. Bailey Williams, that's a beauty. Far side. Put that down for a big moment. They go out wide. They're going to have to come back inboard. Set it up. Rotham, Barris. They'll try again. Luke Edwards is up the ground. That's the way the kick will go. He has to go for it, Luke Edwards. Naismith arrived. Numbers just favour Richmond at the fall. It's now Martin who got it from Graham, who goes wide again. Kick over the top. LaFau tries to claim it. Just gets rid of Tom Cole. Ragdolled him into the pocket. Over the head. Oh, well done though by Hoff. Did well. Hand pass. That's not great. Sold a man into trouble. A little bit obvious. We'll have a ball up in the right forward pocket for Richmond. 2-1-13. The Eagles are a point. The Tigers are up and about thanks to Mate Internet and Mobile. Tap down Williams. Bailey. LaFau. Hand pass back. Dusty gets the fend off with the left. Kick around the corner to the top of the goal square. Good mark taken by Rotham. Done a couple of good things early. Campbell's got to get back.
He started with that matchup on Dustin Martin, but it looks like Dusty's spending a bit more time in the midfield.
Rotham tries to relieve the pressure for the Eagles. Goes wide. Waterman up. Good mark. Kind of lost it. So Waterman has started strongly, apart from a pretty poor effort for goal. He's a long way up the ground. He's got a good tank. Goes short to Cole. He's fighting for his spot in the lineup too, let me tell you. He goes short to Witherden, who came in as the late change. But everyone's getting frustrated here by the Eagles. That's because Richmond have closed all the outlets, and really West Coast want to go back through the middle at the moment. That's all been closed off. Oh, poor kick. Josh Rotham, too much on the kick. Outside the boot. Play on. Didn't travel the distance. Bolton will kick around the corner. Josh Rotham's kicking is why he doesn't get games, and he didn't hit a target. Went over the head of his teammate. I think it was Hoff. And that's pretty poor by everyone involved. And Richmond, again, make them pay. When Martin and Bolton are in the area, you can't make a mistake. And Richmond are seizing on a pretty hapless West Coast. 3-1-19, Richmond, 12 gone. West Coast are a point. This is looking ugly. The Mac family range is back. Here's Paul Hazelby.
And turning over from a slow play. Normally with a slow play, you just want to occupy possession, make them defend a little bit, but they've lost their confidence with ball in hand, the West Coast Eagles. Josh Rotham back into the side in recent times after injury, out of contract at the end of this year. He needs to tidy up a few things in his game, but they make him pay, the Tigers. He's looking ominous. The two of them, Dustin Martin and also Shea Bolton. Great start to this match.
Back in the middle. Graham gets it out to Baker. Pitching ball to half forward. Mansell. Hand pass again, Baker. Left knee strap, but still moving beautifully. Lafau on the lead. Too good for Barris. Marks it on the 50. Good stuff. Really good stuff. This crowd is silent. They came here expecting something. Their team has delivered nothing. And Richmond are absolutely foot on throat stuff early. Good to watch. The Tigers chasing their second win. Lafau from 50 metres. Already kicked one. Squares the ball. Top of the square. Who marks it? Nobody. Brockman in the fluoro boots. Got a problem. Gets it back. Hand pass now to Witherden. Hoff in support. Off one step. Goes out wide. Petrocelli's out muscled. Going to get a free. Got pulled out of the contest. Not happy. A free kick going to Petrocelli.
Just stagnant though, aren't they? Not working together. Opening up space for one another.
Darling marks on the wing. Good lead up. Good presentation by Jack Darling. Had a couple of moments early. Now kicks it long to where he should be. Jack Williams is caught in the pack, but getting in the front. That's a very good mark. Mark's been taken there by Kaczynski. Doing a bit of rucking on the defensive 50. Up and under kick towards the wing. Underneath it, Hoff. Pick it. Tap back. Hoff again. Duggan with the right. Goes out wide. Does it stay in for Jimby? It does. He's got some help back wide in Witherden. Little 1-2. Oh, that sold him into a world of hurt here. And Jimby wants the safety of the boundary line. And the ball goes over. And Richmond are all over this West Coast Eagles who can't get any continuity to their game. 3-1-19 the Tigers. 1 point West Coast. 14 gone. We'll go down to the boundary in a moment. Spitwater tough and ready. See what Chris Klafounis has got for us as we have a throw in far side. Here's Paul Hazelby.
Baker up to 6 disposals now through the midfield.
EJ's Halal Financial Services stats. Graham now, that kick inside 50. Cole, oh, he dropped the mark and then fell over. He does a lot of that, spends more time on the grass than he does on his feet. Oh, well done by Baker around the corner. And another mistake by the Eagles is punished. This time Tom Cole has dropped a sitter and then fell over just to make injury. Put salt under the wound, and Baker has seized the opportunity. And this is good by Richmond, poor by the Eagles. And I tell you what, this game is already getting very close to looking over. 4-1-25 to 1 point. Here's Paul Hazelby.
Harley Reid comes off the ground, yet to touch the footy. It's been all the Tigers through the midfield, and they are punishing those turnovers. He initially did the right thing, Tom Cole, getting in front of that one, but dropped the mark and then just couldn't go with him. The follow-up from Baker, he's been outstanding. 7 disposals through the midfield. He's been played predominantly this season as a high half forward, but with the injuries, he's been the one that's gone into the middle. And what a start by him. They did this last week, didn't they, the Tigers? Very good early in the contest.
Actually fell over twice, Tom Cole, after he dropped the mark, and then when he was chasing Liam Baker. And Curvis, too big in that centre contest to Jack Williams. Now gets it down to Kelly, though. Kelly was pushed when he kicked it. Ball just trickles to half forward. Vlosten over it. Hand pass, tunnels it out. Over it now is Dow. Hand pass loose. Yo, West Coast have got to win some of these contests. Taken high, should get a free kick and doesn't. Cannot believe Yo didn't get a free kick for that. Dan Curvis got away, one tackle, then two. Got a hand pass to Dow. Hand pass back in the middle. Now it spills Petrocelli to Kelly. Kelly now will just lace out. Coming out is Waterman. Probably should have had a shot for goal. Miller does well for the Tigers. Comes towards the interchange wing. Bolton marks it in between two West Coast Eagles. In Jimby and Witherden down the line. Poor kick. Kosicki wanted it outside. Barris wanted it inside, and Barris took a sliding mark for relief for the West Coast Eagles on the wing.
Best look for the West Coast Eagles. Tim Kelly coming out the front of the stoppage, but two of the forwards, Darling and Waterman, leading to the same spot.
Big fly over the top, and Vlosten has taken a huge mark. He and Bailey Williams, contender for mark of the day already. Goes short to Miller. Someone might want to play on this bloke, whoever it is. I know it's an Eagles forward, but he's absolutely got the ball on a string. There's the kick down the line. No mark taken. Hand pass Barris. Now it comes and going to ground, Rotham. We'll have another ball up inside forward 50 for the Tigers. 4-1-25. They lead by four goals. West Coast are 1 point. We've gone 17 first quarter for Mate Internet and Mobile.
That's the best mark I think we've seen so far this season. Nick Vlosten.
Tap down. Close to the boundary line and out. Let's go down to Chris Clafounas on the boundary line. He's there for Spitwater Tough and Ready. High pressure cleaners, tools, not toys.
Thanks, Goss. Frustration building with West Coast fans. Every missed handball, every loopy handball and kick is really getting up there, Godin. You can just feel it building, the tension as West Coast struggle more and more to get the footy.
51 metres out. There's the throw in now. Ralph Smith trying to break the tackle. Chesser going nowhere. Umpire will ball it up 55 out Richmond's end of the ground. Tom Brown comes onto the ground for Miller. Well-deserved break. 18 gone first quarter. 60 metres out, this ball up. So not what the Eagles fans wanted coming into this game. MEGT gives us Paul Hazelby, our expert. We all thought that West Coast would be up for the fight today, but Richmond have seized on many, many, many turnovers and mistakes. Hand pass Kelly to Jinby with that left foot kick. Round the corner. Bailey Williams, again, just numbers for Richmond. They make them pay. There's the left foot kick by Graham, inside 50. Coming out, Kosicki taps it down. Graham, good follow-up. Where are the West Coast Eagles followers? They're not there. And getting in front and taking the mark is Rioli. Duggan thought it was going to be a deep kick, and Tom Cole, as he does so well, pointing to everyone but his own man. And Rioli's going to go back for goal, and he's going to be 30 metres out on a slight angle. There's a lot of pointing on the Eagles defenders. But I would imagine, Paul Hazelby, if you've got a man, stand on him.
That's all you got to do. Go with your man, beat your man. And if you've got him covered, then look to help your teammate. But right now, through the midfield, they're all pointing and talking to each other as well. Kelly and Yo. But he just needs to cash in on this one. Rioli, he's had a terrific start.
He has. He hasn't hit the scoreboard major. He has this time, though. He pushed it out. No, he hasn't. Gee, I thought it was working its way back. 4-2-26 to a point. He has had three genuine chances. Hasn't been rewarded with a major yet. Two goals to Shea Bolton. That doesn't surprise anyone. Baker was a beauty in the foul. He's showing a clean pair of heels so far to Tom Barris. The kick by Duggan. Just a little same old kick towards the wing. Knocked down by Bailey Williams. Numbers at the back. Daniel Rioli. Hand pass. Intercepted by Chesser. Ran past the footy. Not so McIntosh. Loose ball now. Hand pass Edwards. Kelly. Hand pass goes to ground. Taken by Bailey Williams. Dumped in the tackle. A number. Well done, Daniel Rioli. Hand pass over the top for Dow. Running onto it, Rioli. Coming the other way, Cole. Cole goes to ground. Ball comes again. Chesser. Hand standing up in the tackle. Witherden. Just got ball to boot. No, he didn't. Holding the ball. They tackle Bolton. They are fierce, the Tigers, and they're getting true reward for their effort. Ream, except nothing less than Australia's best Ream. Long kick, strong kick, hits the post. Broad, short, actually, it was Jaden Short. 4-4, they're lucky West Coast, because this game could be well and truly over. They're out here, West Coast. Tom Cole marks and plays on. Noah Long playing for his spot on the side, I reckon. There's the chip down the line. Petrocelli leads and gets it. Too far out to score, 4-3, 27 to a point. Transition football for West Coast, but they look up and the Tigers have got huge numbers inside 50. Petrocelli's kick smothered off the boot. They're going to get back here. There's the kick around the corner. Lafau marks it. Brown made the initial mistake, but goes and reward fixes it up now. Lafau a long way down from the forward line, down the line. Ralph Smith, too much time holding the ball. Umpire surely, no, didn't dispose of it. No free kick. Tell you what, they're getting a good rub of the green too, the visitors. Doesn't happen very often in WA. Quick kick, inside 50. Kosicki drops the mark. Rotham now, all very elegant. Comes wide to Yo, wide to Darling. Drops the mark, Darling, but his work rate is up. There's no doubt about that. Down the line, kick. Waterman, half volley. The guy wanted no prior. Little of a ball up, Jack Graham there, the Tigers, right in front of the interchange area.
It's all wide though, isn't it, for the Eagles? They look like they're moving it quickly, but just getting stuck on the wings. No corridor attack just yet in this game.
Williams, Bailey, boundary, taken to ground. Throw in, right in front of Chris Klafoumas, who works the boundary line for Ream. Also Spitwater, tough and ready. Adam Simpson looks on and looks a troubled man. Has been coaching from the boundary line a lot this year, but today in the box. Richmond are good, really good today. On song, the Tigers. Good to see. Hand pass Chessa. Harley Reid, take it high. Baker was the tackler.
His first touch, Harley Reid.
Tried to break the tackle, but he's a hard man to get away from. Is Baker. A kick by Reid, inside 50. Who wants to fly? Brockman will fly. No mark taken. Broad was there. Loose ball. Petricelli needs to flick it up or get it towards Noah Long. Quick kick with the left. Numbers behind the ball. Lost and far too easy for the Tigers. They hook the kick. Duggan's running towards it. So too Morris Rioli. It's a foot race. Rioli's really quick. Can he keep it in front of him? Taps it once. Taps it twice. Then comes back inboard. Well done, Rioli. Kick over the top towards the half forward line. Oh, whacked in the face. Plainly he got free kick there. Hoff didn't get it, but the ball's going to come out now to Duggan. He'll go short. Good run from Edwards at half forward now. Too far out to score. He was looking to come inboard. 4-3-27 Richmond. 1 point West Coast. 23 gone. Not going to be a long quarter. Close to the man on the mark again, West Coast. Darling, Waterman, Williams at the back. Nankervis is there. Feigning for a free. Petricelli, nothing doing. This is all happening 30 metres out. Right forward pocket for the Eagles. We'll have another ball up.
Getting their numbers back well in defence, the Tigers. Big cluster of numbers. West Coast just a bit slow with their ball movement. As we said, getting stuck wide.
Missing boot. Tap down. Brockman. Kelly. Pocket. Squares it. Richmond have numbers. Brown at the back. Here goes Chessa. Oh, getting back there. Oh, just manhandled it brilliantly by Pickett. Did really well. A little 1-2-2. They're going to be under pressure here, but cool heads prevail by the Tigers. Tom Cole there. Pushed underneath the footy. Rotham's there. Cole over the top. Rotham over him. And we're going to have a ball up left half forward. What about that by Marlon Pickett in the last line? Paul Hazelby.
Just the speed. He's always had that. Got back. He was out of position, but with one or two strides was able to catch up to Chessa, who had a great opportunity to score.
Williams down towards Harley Reid. Quick hand pass to Tom Cole. Inside 50. Darling! Good mark. Strong mark in front of Young. And Jack Darling, I saw him warm up from this exact spot. 30 metres out, 45-degree angle. It was like a 6-foot putt on a putting green. He's lining up for goal and a much-needed one for the Eagles, closing in on quarter time.
There's the Harley Reid effect inside the contest. Able to win the ball and just got spun in the tackle, got his arms free and released a teammate in space.
511 goals in his career, Jack Darling. The whipping boy for the Eagles at the moment. 45 metres out, kicks the goal, and the West Coast Eagles are on the board. Big Jack is back, and the Eagles get their first. 1-1-7, Tigers 4-3-27, and that is on the Mate Internet and Mobile scoreboard. Here's Paul Hazelby for MEGT, Australia's apprenticeship experts.
Well, they needed two players to stand up today, the West Coast Eagles, if they had any chance. And they're their senior players. Tim Kelly is one through the midfield. He started really well with the 7 disposals. And Jack Darling is the other one. Gets a reward, kicks a goal. But his effort has been there. Last week they said he won the trademark award, even though he didn't hit the scoreboard. It's just a matter of time. If you put in the effort and you do the hard yards, do the team things, you will get rewarded. And hopefully for Jack it is today. They needed that. Down by 3 goals, though, given the domination by the Tigers. They're still in this contest.
Tim Kelly with 7 disposals. So too Ben Miller, Jack Graham, Liam Baker and Nick Boston. Back in the middle. Harley Reid getting busy. Flick back. Duggan got it from Yo. Off a step. Inside the last couple of minutes of the quarter. Up and under in the breeze. Holding there as Cripps. Barely called his name. Boston has took a great mark earlier in the quarter. And will have a ball up to the point of left half forward for the West Coast Eagles. Richmond have dominated on mistakes from the West Coast Eagles. Dow was feigning for a free, didn't get it. Oh, what a problem. He went the hand pass and didn't. The umpire still waving his hands around. Coming back to Chesser. He received it from Yo. Brockman's arguing with the umpire. Not worth worrying about, mate. The ball's left the zone. It's now coming to Darling. Needs to bend over. Gives it. Harley Reid. Snap over the left for the right. Goal! West Coast get their second. And Harley Reid's making a difference. 2-1-13. 4-3-27. Back-to-back goals. Well played, Jack Darling. Well played, Harley Reid.
He sparked them last week against Sydney, didn't he, with that goal early. And he was the one that set up that handball with the goal to Jack Darling that released the inside 50 kick. And this time pushing forward. We haven't seen too much of him inside the forward line. He has gone down there, but because West Coast have struggled in their early games, haven't seen him one-on-one. That's a great sign. Really good goal sense around his body. Straight in front. I just knew he had to get good purchase on that footy. It was great positioning in front of Jack Darling in the vision of Darling, who had his head over the ball. Eagles back in it.
Ream accept nothing less than Australia's best Ream. Couple of goals in a minute. I reckon Adam Simpson wouldn't have seen any of those. He's in the lift and he's walking around the boundary line as we see. Here's Kelly, sides his way through Tim Kelly on the dominance from Bailey Williams inside the square. Waterman marks it! What a mark! Opposed to Miller, and that is a genuine contested mark directly in front, and Tim Kelly take a bow.
Great centre clearance. That's his second contested mark inside the forward 50. He's not the biggest player. Miller is obviously 198 centimetres. So Jake finding a way, just protecting where the ball's going to land and having one last movement towards the ball. Solid hands. He's always showed that he's got that ability. Of course, they had Jack Darling in form. They had Josh Kennedy. Had to bide his time. But the time is now. He's the number one inside their forward 50.
Waterman, three goals in 2 minutes. West Coast have come from the clouds. In the space of 120 seconds, they've reduced the margin to just 8 points. Goals to Darling, Reid and Waterman. It's 4-3 to 3-1. We've got 8 seconds left on the clock, first quarter, for Mate Internet Mobile, and they are running hot. West Coast for Ream.
Well, this is what we expected through the midfield. Tim Kelly, Elliot Yo, Harley Reid up against Jack Graham, who's getting some opportunity in there. Liam Bacon, not normally a recognised full-time midfielder, but it was the Tigers early. Right now, West Coast getting back on top through the midfield and getting some good looks inside their 450.
Inside 50s, 14 Richmond, 10 West Coast. West Coast leading 9-6 in the clearances and 6-4 in the stoppage clearances. They are some of the stats for Hijaz Halal Financial Services. Closing seconds of the quarter. Eagles fans, Harley Reid, good back feed to Kelly. Off a step, kick was smothered down. Siren sounds. And it's amazing what 2 minutes can do. There would have been some hollering and hooting going on if they hadn't got busy. And they did in those lazy last couple of minutes. But Richmond holds sway, started strongly, and still lead by 8 points. 4-3-27, Richmond. The Tigers, West Coast, 3-1-19, 29-39, has how long the quarter went for. This is AFL Nation for 4-20 Pies and the TAC.
That quarter on AFL Nation was for Mate Internet and Mobile. $20 off for 5 months with Mate Internet.
Here from the biggest names in sport on SEN.
Drives the field goal right up the lane.
Catch up on all the latest scores and news in the time it takes to get from the car park to the office with SEN's The Day's Play.
Chris Golding, bang!
Our team of expert commentators go over the results, cover the big talking points, plus share the match highlights and big moments.
Goals here to Robinson. Edge to Tonga!
SEN's The Day's Play. The Day's Play. Thanks to Drinkwise. If you're choosing to have a drink, choose to Drinkwise.
Flat footy moments to avoid this season. The turnstile.
Mate beats mate at the gate. Match day tickets are on the mobile. Lining up to scan through. No! What's happened here? His phone's flat. He can't access the tickets.
Stay charged with a Signet power bank. Compact and lightweight, it fits in your pocket, and you'll never be flat when it's time to tap and go. Signet power banks, available at signet.com as well as in-store at JB Hi-Fi and other leading retailers.
When you want-
walk into OMF, it's okay to close your eyes. We encourage it, in fact, because all we're suggesting is after you've looked somewhere else, check out our signature range of mattresses or even OMF's best value bed-in box mattresses. Come and have a lie down. Simply see how you feel. And then open your eyes and look at the price. You might just see that you'll be 100% comfy.
The game of footy, it's all about interpretation. Like when a well-designed kick dribbles over the boundary line, the crowd roars, "Deliberate!" Well, there's no misinterpreting your intentions when you get hold of a delicious 4-20 king-size sausage roll. This is footy's snack food version of a big barrel straight up the guts. So when you cross that line from hungry to famished, don't waste time dishing off a cute handball. The sausage roll is your route one to goal. 4-20, deliberately delicious.
That roast chicken? Maybe halal? That snack pack? Yep, halal. Dad's investment portfolio? How on earth would you tell? Talk to Hijaz Financial Services, helping Muslim Australians secure halal super, home loans and investments. Hijaz Financial Services, definitely halal. Hijazfs.com.au.
This information is provided by Hijaz Financial Advisors, PTY LTD, AFSL 517686 and Hijaz Islamic Credit Solutions, PTY LTD, ACL 480542 and does not take into account your objectives, financial situation or needs.
Hi, Josh Kennedy here. Have you received an electricity or gas price increase? Or you're worried about rising energy costs? Give Red Energy a call. Their Aussie-based team will give you a no-obligation energy bill comparison, and you might be surprised by what they have to offer. Plus, Red Energy is owned by Snowy Hydro, a leader in renewable energy. Give 100% Australian-owned Red Energy a call today on 131 806 or visit redenergy.com.au.
Eligibility criteria and conditions apply.
Thanks to Flight Centre, the Melbourne Mavericks are giving one lucky fan the chance to win a massive $10,000 Flight Centre gift voucher to use to build and experience your ultimate holiday. For your chance to win, make sure you fly over to the Melbourne Mavericks home game on April 14 or 27. Support your Mavericks and you'll go into the draw. It's all thanks to Flight Centre. Book with your very own travel expert in-store today.
If you love chasing, pacing and racing, we've got it all covered on SEN Track. With a stellar lineup of shows round the clock, we've got exactly what you need. Like Giddy Up with Gareth Hall.
Join me for Giddy Up with the biggest news and opinions every morning.
Saturday Trackside.
Oh, here I come, baby. Let down.
And live shows every night.
Are you allergic to horses?
Listen live on SEN Track and the SEN app. SEN Track, your home of chasing, pacing and racing every day of the week.
You're listening to AFL Nation for 4-20. You can't have footy without a 4-20 pie. Macca's I'm Loving It Moments. Macca's new surprise fries.
And Rioli, Morris, Bowles kicking to the man on the bar. Might get lucky. They'll have another crack at it. Kick around the corner. It is a goal. Oh, well done by Baker around the corner. And another mistake by the Eagles is punished. This time Tom Cole has dropped a sitter and Baker has seized the opportunity. 45 metres out, kicks the goal and the West Coast Eagles are on the board. Big Jack is back. It's now coming to Darling. Needs to bend over. Gives it. Harley Reid. Step over the left and the right. Goal! West Coast get their second. Bailey Williams inside the square. Three goals in 2 minutes. West Coast have come from the clouds. AFL Nation for 4-20. Traveller here's Paul Hazelby. He's our expert for MEGT Australia's apprenticeship experts. 8 points, Richmond.
All the Tigers early, but all the Eagles late in that quarter. The disposals in the end, it was Richmond 80, 79 to West Coast. The clearances in favour of West Coast, plus two. Turnovers, plus two to West Coast. The inside 50s, 14-10. In favour of the Tigers. And the marks inside 50. Six the Tigers had, only three for the West Coast Eagles.
Hijaz Halal Financial Services. More from Paul Hazelby in a moment. Yo, hands and knees. Williams, Graham, a dive on top of him. Yo, the umpire's allowing this ball to go pinballing around. So why the turnaround, Paul?
Well, they started to win the ball around the clearance. Tim Kelly got busy, Yo got busy. Harley Reid come back onto the ground and had some influence in that quarter. And their forwards all of a sudden got some speed on the ball and had some good looks. One-on-one, they're able to take your opportunities. Tim Kelly up to 9 disposals. Miller had 7, as did Graham, Duggan and Baker for the Tigers. Elliot, Yo, Vlosten, Darling all up to 6 disposals.
Good kick by Ian Curvis from a free kick. First time we've really seen McGovern take a floating mark. He'll go wide to Noah Long. That's ignored. Now he's called to play on. Goes to Josh Roth. Very elegant when he kicks it, Josh, but does burn the footy. Runs a long way. There's another opportunity where he basically kicked it to the chest of Vlosten. Hunt is there. He'll try to wrestle the ball from him. It's a ball up right in front of Chris Klifounis, who's on the boundary line for Spitwater, tough and ready. Chris.
Yeah, Hayes, you mentioned Harley Reid coming back into the game after that spell on the bench early in the first quarter. He was on the blower with the coach's box for about 2 minutes while he was sitting on the bench. Came back on and managed to be very effective in the game.
Good call. Kane McAuliffe threw the ball up. Yo taken to ground. There's the quick kick. Getting across Vlosten. Crashes the pack. Loose ball in the middle. Jinby, he got taken high too. Didn't get a free. Yes, he did. Non-controlling umpire.
Good attack. Nick Vlosten first in the marking contest. Then Ruben Jinby at ground level. Comes up a bit ginger. He's got a corky.
He certainly does. And the trainers are trying to get out there too. I think they're trying to get out to Cripps and also Vlosten and Hunt. There's the kick by Jinby. He is real ginger. Inside 50. Jack Williams. Over the top. And Jack Williams has taken the mark. He'll need every bit of 52 and a half metres. But, gee, that's a good mark. That's a confidence booster for the young fella. He'll line up for goal.
He's been going about his business quietly this year. Got the goal last week. He's a good size, though, isn't he?
He's a big boy.
Had a pretty good season. The same year in the Colts system when Jai Amos was taken from the Fremantle Dockers. He was number 2 on the goal-kicking list. And I thought he was a bargain for the West Coast Eagles. And it looks like they have a developing young foot on their hands.
Jinby trying to get off the ground now. Kicked 7 goals in his career. Jack Williams, he's given it everything. Jack Williams from 51 and a half metres. And the Eagles have kicked 4 in a row. TAC, Priest can be anywhere at AFL Nation for the 4-20 traveller. Jack Williams gets his first. And the Eagles reduce the margin to 2 points. Paul Hazelby.
Well, he's big enough, isn't he? He's already a big lad. He'll just harden up a little bit in terms of his body shape over time and bring that athleticism to his game. But they'd be really happy with that. Contested mark alongside what we've seen from Jake Waterman. It's a good contest too from Jack Darling. Still probably waiting for Oscar Allen to come back into this team. But the future all of a sudden looks brighter than it did probably 12 months ago with an ageing key forward list.
MEGT, Australia's apprenticeship experts, gives us Paul Hazelby, best in the business. Elders, you can rely on Elders. The score, 4-3 to 4-1. Richmond lead by 2 points. Then Curvis wins it down. Yo backpedals. Harley Reid zigs and zags and then zags and then has a bounce. And then arches the back again. Has a second bounce. Top of the square. Long inside the pocket. Kick was off target. But the mark's been taken by Waterman. Alongside the left-hand behind post, Waterman, who's kicked one in the first, really should be stepping to his right and bending it around, and the Eagles have a chance to kick 5 goals in a row. Waterman does. He's a multi-goal kicker. He's got 2, and West Coast are in front. 5-1-31, 4-3-27 for Elders. Looking for an agent you can rely on. Trust the team at Elders Real Estate. Here's Paul Hazelby.
There's the midfield that we were talking about before the game. Elliot Yo, he's had a big start in this second quarter. He's had the 3 disposals already as he comes from the bench. But just winning the ball on the inside, giving it to Harley Reid, who, for the first time, we actually saw a lot of dash from the stoppage. And he's done his homework on Big Nan Curvis. He knows that he's not the greatest runner. And he just looked at him and said, "You cannot catch me." And off he went, straightened up. In the end, he was probably going for goal. Ambitious, but really well read, wasn't he, in the air from Jake Waterman. He's Jukes at the moment, and his ability to read the outswinging ball far superior than anybody else in that contest.
Yo comes off the ground. Brockman goes into the middle. Tap down, coming off the square. Pickett runs a long way. He ran a long way without bouncing it. Hand pass, they go forward into the ball. Poor kick. That touched off the boot. Barris was there to intercept anyway. Wide kick, Chesser. And defensive 50. Down the line to his good mate, Noah Long. Good teams just chip up 30 and 40 here. Saw Geelong today. They just used the ball so beautifully. So too Port Adelaide. There's the kick. not a great kick. Williams Bailey at the back of the pack. Jack Williams is there for West Coast. Hand pass back now. They run across the defensive goal line. Look out. Just got the kick away. This is better by the Eagles. That's a throw and not punished. 42. I think his name's Nick McGuinness. He is refusing to blow his whistle for a free kick today. Yes, Nicholas McGuinness, number 42. Hope he's got the block out on him. Fair skin fella. There's the kick by Chesser. Not a great one. Clint bowls everyone inside 50. Tumbling ball. Williams is there. Nowhere. Another ball up inside the shade of the stand. Eagles end of the ground. They lead by 4 points. We've gone 6 minutes.
Infectious right now for the West Coast Eagles. Great chase down from Waterman, and then Campbell Chesser following it up with a big tackle.
Backed out of there by Nan Curvis with the left. Relieves some pressure momentarily. Clean bowls everyone. McGovern and Bailey Williams were on the wrong page together. That should have been a McGovern ball, and they're going to pay the price here. They get away with it inside the pocket, and Dusty Martin. That was terrible by McGovern and Bailey Williams. They had the ball. They just needed to decide who wanted it. Now they've turned it over. Big fly, mark taken by Hoff. And paid the mark.
Goodbye, Hoff. One of the challenges he's going to have today is not to get preoccupied by Bolton. If the ball's there to go for, back yourself in. And he did that time.
Shelley's standing on his own on this interchange wing. No one's seen him yet. Bailey Williams will fly, take a very good mark.
Harley Reid wants it in the corridor.
So he tutors. Check for Shelley. He played the wings, not a great kick. Dropping the mark though. West Coast at the back of the pack. Noah Long. Waterman works his way through. Darling. Been busy, Darling. Got us sold himself into problems. Needed first thoughts, your best thought, Jack. Do the bread and butter stuff. Turned it over abroad. Come back again. They dash through Daniel Rioli. Right through the middle of the box. Just shows a lot of the footy. Well done, Rotham. Punches it away from Dusty Martin. Harley Reid was taken high. Does he get a free? No. We'll have a ball up far wing. 5-1-31, 4-3-27 for Elders. You can rely on Elders. Ball up.
Boys, Ruben Jimby is looking ready to come back on. He's been seen by the physios. He's been on the bike. He was about to come back on and then got called back to the phone from Adam Simpson. About to come back on again. Elliot Yeo brought him back to have a chat.
Spit water, tough and ready. Ball back in the middle. Spear it out towards Morris Rioli. Started well. Has the ball at left half forward. Then chips over the top. Missed his target. Going to land fortuitously, though, to Baker. His left is going into the pocket, and Bolton should mark and does. Off gave him too much rope. Thought he was going to go long. Bolton was the option. And he's a very good footballer. He's about 3 metres in from the boundary line. Christopher Funnis is right behind this shot. And Bolton is lining up for his third goal to put the Tigers back in front.
Well, he had the two options, didn't he, Rioli? And I reckon he just went over the first one, but it was the right call. Went long and got it inside the forward 50, and well read, it was quite open, but the ball was moving all the time.
Great kick. He is a star of the game, Shea Bolton. He's kicked three. Nothing fancy about that. Just a trademark drop punt, and the Tigers respond. 5-3-33, 5-1-31 for Elders. You can rely on Elders. And we'll check his stats in a moment for Hijaz Halal Financial Services. Paul Haysby's our expert for MEGT.
He's a megastar. He can do everything. What a luxury it is when he goes up into the midfield, he changes the way the game's been played, and then at the right time he can go forward and he gets space, and if there's speed on the ball, he's hard to stop. I mentioned the challenge for Brady Hoft, just to make sure that he's keeping an eye not only on him but also the person with the ball. They will give the cues and the signals. Just couldn't read them on that occasion. He's now got three goals to go with six disposals.
Good response by the Tigers. They seem to have steadied. And Curvis wins it down. Dow coming one way. He's going to ball it up secondary circle. 5-3 to 5-1. Nine gone second term. Kelly's there. They just sort of seem to have worked on him over the last couple of minutes to stop his dominance in the midfield. Yeo back on the ground. Brockman now in the middle. Tapped down by Bailey Williams to the outside. Cole, definite touch there, Cole. Good. Brockman, Bailey Williams, took a long time to kick it, and that ricochet boy, it was a smother by Baker to Dow, to Baker again, LaFau, well done by Barris, good spoil, hand pass over the top, hand pass now Witherden, guess who, Cole left it behind, hatched it, then tackles, then well done by Yeo, taps it out to Bailey Williams, takes a long time to get hand to ball this time, now it comes to Brockman, an underround kick, that was deliberate, now it comes out to Chesser, has a bounce, what's his options, he's got Cripps short, he goes to him and honours the lead. I think it might have been intended for Darling, but Cripps was asking for it earlier. And Cripps will line up, rarely called his name. He'll line up for goal directly in front.
Great movement by the West Coast. He goes straight through the corridor because he had options, didn't he? Brockman out the far side, but he came back on the inside and just opened up. Dustin Martin didn't want to put in the hard yards to chase down Campbell Jessa. Two different speeds and a really good finish. Just lowered the eyes. How often we see players run their distance and then just blaze away.
289 goals in his career. Make that 290. Needed every bit of 50. West Coast respond. They're going upstairs. Thanks to Imar Insurance, the Shed Imar's loyalty program. The umpire's call is a goal. Just checking whether it snicked the post. I don't think it did.
Best sponsorship in footy, crypto.com.
And Imar Insurance, the Shed Imar's loyalty program. Let me just tell you, it has taken the wind out of the team and fan celebrations, and they've got to do something about it and do it fast.
They've got to eliminate it, Tim. 100% agree. Jamie Cripps, though, he just continues to get better as a player. Hasn't been cited too much today, but he works so hard. Some days it works where you hit the scoreboard all the time. Others, it's quite difficult playing that position. He's been doing it for 14 years now.
The Eagles are setting up for a kick. The Eagles are setting up for it. It's a goal. West Coast respond. 6-1, 37 to 5-3, 33. I just hate it. I'm sorry. I just hate it. It's a blight on the game. A lack of courage by goal umpires. The amount of times we go upstairs. The wind, the air gets sucked out of our game.
Yeah. It's like soccer, isn't it? When we see a great goal in soccer and then you've got to go back through the review process. The emotion of our game when a goal is scored is the greatest thing that we have. Fans are up and about, players are up and about, and then to review the process and
take time
out of the
game. You know they've done away with linesmen in tennis, don't you? They've done away with linesmen in tennis.
Yep, 100%.
They should do away with goal umpires. Get rid of them. They're a blight on our game. Elders, you can rely on elders. They do a job. You've got to get two goal umpires at either end. You umpire that post to that post, and you do that post to that post, and we're done. No excuses. They can consult then and there, and we don't even have to go upstairs. Tapped down by Bailey Williams. Kelly. Tackled by Dow. Shovels it out. Well done to Yo. Did well, Kelly. Inside 50. Petricelli gets rid of his man in Vlosten. Coming back now. Broad with the left. It's a white. Gee, that's a good kick under pressure. The mark's been taken by Hugo Ralph Smith. Brockman stands the mark. 4 points West Coast. Richmond kicked the first four goals of the game. Down the line. Punched away from Dan Curvis by Bailey Williams. Shea Bolton has kicked three and the ball goes over the line and out of play. Multiple goal kicker for the Eagles, Jake Waterman. Three goals to Bolton. He knew he was going to deliver. Shallow throw in. Ruckman was so far back. Harley Reid knew what was going on. His hand pass was smothered down. He's going to come back in. Look out. Bang. Coming the other way. Well done by Duggan. Offloaded. There's the kick with the left. Jack Darling punched to the ground. West Coast have numbers here. Hand pass. Petricelli got it from Brockman. Open forward line. Chips over the top. Needs a kind bounce. Needs no bounce. He kicks it straight through the middle. Harley Reid was the only one who knew that that was going to be an ordinary boundary throw. And albeit his hand pass was smothered, he was ahead of the curve right there. And it all set things up. West Coast get a mini lead now. 7-1, 43 to 5-3, 33. Jaden Short has gone off. His sub has been activated. Must be injured. And Sonsi comes on. So the Tigers must have a problem. 10 points to margin. 7-1, 5-3. 15 gone. Thanks to Elders. You can rely on Elders. Here's Paul Hazelby.
Well, you can see his thought process when it dropped short. He wanted to go and take it out of the ruck, but you can't do that. You've got to wait for it to hit the ground if you're not the nominated ruckman. But he was first with the ball. He's so clever. But really good work there from Petricelli. Just cut back on the inside. Been a bit of a goal kicker this year for the West Coast Eagles. And he's also been pretty handy in the air as well. He'll do his confidence a world of good.
Some news, Josh Gablich reporting. Stephen Cornelio has avoided serious knee injury. Small medial tear, will miss two games. Some lucky news there for GWS fans as we go around the grounds. Thanks to Chemist Warehouse. Heading to Chemist Warehouse for great savings every day. McGovern left the foul. In the meantime, left the ball behind. Straightening up. Kicked by Pickett. Misses. Did everything right, Pickett. Had time. Had time to steady. Kick was nice. To the right. West Coast bring the ball in. 5-4, 34, 7-1, 43. 9 points the margin. Tom Cole trades the ball with Witherden and goes wide to Noah Long. I always wonder why they kick the ball high to Noah Long. They've never quite worked it out. He's only a little man and they always kick it on his head and it makes it easy to defend. The ball goes over the line now to play. They've done it all year. 7-1-5-4, 9 points West Coast.
He's a smart forward. That's why he's a centre-half forward stuck in a little man's body. He just presents up. That's why he's going to be a good player because he gets in the right spots.
Keep in front of him though, play.
I agree.
Loose ball, West Coast. Off a step, Chesser starting to get busy. Spiral ball to half forward, Darling. Loose ball, give it, Jack. Hand pass, he does. Hand pass again, there is Long. Cripps. Well done by Richmond. Daniel Rioli. Hand pass out through traffic. That's a sweeping hand pass to Morris Rioli to Ralph Smith. The man who's got a clothing brand named after him. There's the mark taken by Martin at half forward. Flicks it wide. McAuliffe short, and there is Hugo Ralph Smith, who was run down. The mullet flailing in this westerly breeze, easterly breeze, westerly actually, it's going from right to left, and it's been marked about 40 metres out.
That's the benefit of quick ball movement and a quick play on there from Dustin Martin. Just gave the quick handball. Wasn't the perfect kick. It didn't even go to the intended player, but it went at speed. All the defenders rushing back. And just fell into the arms of Ralph Smith, who gets a chance.
Good player, Ralph Smith. The young fellas, young talent coming through for the Tigers. 45-degree angle. Let's put that to the left. It's not a good kick. 5-5-35 to 7-1-43. The marriage is also warming up. Chris Kafunas, keep an eye on who's going to be subbed out here. That's a beautiful kick straight down the middle. So there's a change coming for the West Coast Eagles. I think Ryan Marich is warming up. There's the wide kick. Jack Williams doesn't mark it. Taken by Hunt. Hunt will kick long down the line. There is Harley Reid. Could have gone to the outside. He does. Darling on 50. What does Darling do? He'll chip it down and Yeovil mark it. In the pocket. The West Coast Eagles are also going to activate their sub before halftime. Keep an eye on who that is.
Looks like it might be Luke Edwards, boys. I'll keep you up to date.
Second week in a row that Luke Edwards has gone out of the game early. Kick by Yo around the corner. Got it with the left. And he wants the crowd to lift. West Coast 8-1-49. Tigers are 5-5-35. Thanks to TAC and Elders. You can rely on Elders. Here's Paul Hazelby.
Really smart setup from the West Coast Eagles from the kick in. McGovern looked wide, but the whole time that was happening, they opened up the corridor and there was Petrocelli coming from half forward and just opened up the play. And I've been waiting to see it, Tim. The Harley Reid going forward, getting a one-on-one look, and that was beautiful. Didn't mark it, but won the contested footy at half forward to set up that goal. That is Dustin Martin like. Once he adds that to his game all the time to be able to do it in the centre bounce around the contest, but to go forward, that's when you become a superstar of the competition, and that was a big win. It's then allowed Jack Darling in and a nice finish to find Elliot Yeo, who's had a big quarter. Elliot Yeo, he's had 8 disposals already.
Running hot for Ream, and that's why we've got Chris Kafunas on the boundary line. He's dead right. Luke Edwards concussed and is out of the game. Spitwater tough and ready. High pressure cleaners, tools, not toys. Ball back in the middle. Jaden Hunt forced to defend this, going back the wrong way. Hand pass on the up was good by Sonsi, the sub. Player goes down, no free kick. Kaczynski feigning for a free. Barris over the line. Another throw in 20 metres around. Tackler was LaFoul. Another throw in. Richmond's end of the ground. They trail by 16 points.
Big names get the rub of the green, don't they, inside the forward 50. Like Kaczynski, he's been battling for a while. That should have been a free kick paid to him.
Bailey Williams wins it down with the left. Skipper Duggan. No, going nowhere. 25 out, Richmond's end of the ground. Richmond have always responded, though. First four goals of the game. The Eagles have kicked eight of the last nine. Duggan hacked it out of the air. His pitch does and almost stays in as well. So 55 out. Oh, and the umpire's paid. That is not with lack of intent to keep it in. That's a really tough call.
You know, it's the wrong call when the player that would normally get the free kick is running away from it.
That is a tough call. Inside the pocket. Hoff up, off hands over the line.
Marlon Pickett was running back into position. Didn't even signal that it was insufficient intent to the umpire. It's a harsh game.
35 around, Richmond's end of the ground. 8 minutes to go on the clock in the quarter. Kelly been quiet this quarter. Here is Pickett now, bends it around, top of the square. Barrison, LaFau there. Rotham swats the ball over. Kosicki, where they rushed behind. 5-6, so 11 scoring shots to 9. Richmond's way, a trail by 13 points. Next to Elders, you can rely on Elders. There's the kick, Marek on the ground, short kick. Miller left it behind. Kelly, the look-away hand pass was simply superb. Then he provides good voice to get it to Cripps. Inside 50, Waterman, Miller, Waterman, Waterman, marks it, plays on, Jakey Waterman. To Cripps at right half back. Set that up, and West Coast are out by 19 points on the back of three goals from Jake Waterman. 9-1-55 to 5-6-36. The Elders, you can rely on Elders.
And two goals in a row from kick-in. You don't see that sort of reward too often. So the Tigers falling down in midfield. That was a long kick down the line, but well read by Tim Kelly. He set it up. But just the positioning again and the leading pattern of Jake Waterman. He could have gone wider to the boundary, but he realised and recognised that Jamie Cripps could run 10, 15, 20 metres in front of him, and that gave him the ability to penetrate over the top of the defender. And another contested mark, essentially, inside the forward 50.
9 of the last 10 goals, West Coast, after Richmond kicked the first 4 of the game. Inside 50, Baker being busy. Well done, though, by Rotham, getting across. Loose ball, off one step. They hack it forward, top of the square. Barris is there, no mark. Kosicki doesn't get a free hack forward by Baker again. Through for a minor score.
He looks at the umpire again, Kosicki. For some players, that gets paid. Here we go, another kick-in. Can they get three in a row from the kick-in, West Coast? This time, McGovern.
The Mac family range is back. McGovern has the ball in his hand. He'll go short to Duggan, coming to the interchange side of the ground. He's trapped in the pocket here. He's going to have to take the percentage and kick it down the line. And does. It's a shallow kick, very shallow. Comes to the back. Cripps will be first there. He and Kelly, they raffle it. Harley Reid. Sides his way through. Oh, the hand pass was a little bit extravagant. They're coming again. McAuliffe does really well. Gets it to Graham by hand. Jack Graham's kick. A worm burner. Rioli's there. Does really well. Gets away from Chesser. Kicks into the pocket. McGovern getting back. Punches the ball to ground. Swings the Tigers' opponent also to ground. Duggan comes one way. Intelligent. LaFau. He kicks to the top of the square. And they run in and kick an easy goal. Sonsi the sub. West Coast made hard work of that in the back pocket, let me tell you. Should have taken it out, and Sonsi gets a much-needed one for the Tigers. Not out of it, Tigers fans. Go nowhere. 6-7-43 to 9-1-55. Margin back to two goals. For Elders, you can rely on Elders.
We've got to punish the turnovers. There was one in midfield there from Harley Reid. That gave them the inside 50 entry. But again, just a mix-up there with McGovern. And I think it might have been Tom Cole coming the other way. Well done by the Tigers. They sorted out. Sonsi had worked hard from the far side to get into the goal square. And LaFau, he's a player, making good decisions. Started the game on fire, but gets a goal assist.
Clever by LaFau. Just lowered the eyes. Sonsi was pitched a tent inside the centre square. So Sonsi's on. And Marek is on. So both subs have been activated. Luke Edwards with concussion. Jaden Short is out of the game for the Tigers.
Been a big weekend of subs having an impact too.
Ball back in the middle. Can the Tigers respond with back-to-back? Flicked up by Williams. Well done by Duggan. The two sevens go at it. Baker, far side, umpire lurking. still lurking. Umpire Foot says, I'll ball it up far side. 9-1 to 6-7. West Coast by 2 goals. They led by 19 at one stage. 25 gone. Still plenty of time. Going to be a long quarter. Beautiful tap down by Nankervis. Ricochet ball. Rioli, oh, brilliant. Absolutely brilliant, Morris. Kick a goal, son, and does. Absolutely sensational by Rioli. He has been absolutely all over the scoreboard, but first time it's a major. And that was some Rioli magic of the highest order. 7-7-49 to 9-1-55. And Morris Rioli, that is what people come to the footy for. His 22nd goal of his 32-game career.
He
what
deserved
a goal.
That too, didn't he? He's worked really hard, had some chances. He's growing before our eyes. He was good last week. He now looks like he belongs at this level. His attack on the ball is great. His defensive pressure, outstanding. He just got to bring that goal-king ability that we know all the Riolis have in him or in them. Great finish. And they needed that. They're back in this contest.
Back-to-back goals. Back-to-back goals by the Tigers. It's all happening in here too. They're winning the ball at the middle of the ground. Coming off the square is Noah Long. He's coming on. He's changed sides. Pickett also stands alongside him. Bailey Williams takes it out of the air. Kicks around the corner. Petricelli being held. Come back. Petricelli being held by Ralph Smith.
One of the advantages there, Tim Kelly, that they're onto at the Tigers.
Tigers can firm up behind the ball. 9-1-55, 7-7-49. Eagles got out to a handy lead. Darling punched away from him. Big punch two there by Tyler Young. The ball goes over the line out of play. We'll have a throw in as Harley Reid comes off, replaced by Yo. We'll have a throw in. 25 around Eagles into the ground. Lead by 6 points, 27 gone. Going to be a long quarter.
Elliot Yo, 14. Tim Kelly, 12. Baker's up to 11. Graham's got 10. Duggan and Darling with 9.
Ejaz Halal, Financial Services stats. The Tigers just raffle the ball at half back. That's not good. It's going to come back. Yo's already kicked the goal this quarter. Waterman, brilliant. He just muscled his man and read the ball brilliantly in the air. He is having one heck of a game, Jake Waterman. He's kicked 3. He's lining up for his 4th.
Well, you got to cash in, don't you? And he's doing that today. I think he's been brilliant all season. Just been tough as a forward for West Coast. Missed a couple of shots. He's got 6 on the season. This will make it number 10. Puts him right up there with some of the better forwards.
7 goals in the turn. Can someone check when the last time the Eagles kicked 7 goals in a quarter, please? Because they are absolutely running hot on the scoreboard at least. Red Energy switched to Red Energy. And Waterman's got 4 goals, and West Coast again get out to a 2-goal lead. 10-1-61, the Tigers 7-7-49. For Elders, you can rely on Elders.
They're just getting some good one-on-one looks, aren't they? That's all they need. Nobody coming over the top, nobody folding back as a defence. It was Ben Miller, and it has been Ben Miller a couple of times where he's just been beaten in the air. But his ability to recognise where that ball's going to land and just leave it open, leave it free, and then make the last quick move to that space has been terrific.
Around the grounds, Chemist Warehouse, an A-League score for you. Melbourne City 8, Perth Glory 0. Back in the middle, now out of the middle. Jimby with the left. Darling's there, got a juggle off the line, I think. Golapop put hands behind his back. Richmond players are thinking, did it hit the post? Was it juggled over the line? The goal umpire stepping out. There's a conversation to be had.
Well, the umpire really wanted to pay it. The field umpire, the goal umpire didn't really want a part of it.
About to find out what the goal umpire thinks. Goal umpire's call is a mark. See, this is my point. If the goal umpire thinks it's a mark, then he doesn't get involved. Because his job is to debate the score, not marks or pushing the backs or anything like that. That's a mark. So the mark, and that took 2 seconds to complete, and Darling will go back in between the goal and the point post. That's a good mark by Jack Darling.
Going for his 2nd. He's been good too, Jack. Back to form. This is disposal number 10.
Right alongside the right-hand goalpost. So about to be 8 goals. If he kicks this, 8 goals in a quarter. But you don't want to moz Jack because Jack's likely to kick it straight into the post. When he's on, he's really on. And when he's off, oh dear. Steps around with the left and kicks it out of bounds on the full on the other side.
I don't think they train that, so...
That's the idea part.
You've got to go close to the man on the mark. If you only come out on the left, so the angle is less. He started behind the point post.
Last time he was at 7.25, it was round 2 last year, so a bit over 12 months ago, but still, it's refreshing for them. 10-1-61 to 7-7-49, and that was sloppy by Darling after being paid the mark. It was a pretty poor effort for kick for goal. Noah Long slips over. Pickett stays up, then turns it over. Hand pass Tom Cole. Hand pass now to Cripps. Gets it to Witherden and kick around the corner. Pitching ball. Darling's there. He and Broad go at it. Darling stays, taps it back nicely. Comes back to Petrocelli. Kick around the corner. Petrocelli has kicked the goal of the game. And the bloody goal umpire's going upstairs for the third time in a row. Imar Insurance, the shed. Imar's loyalty program. And the bloody goal umpire for the third time in a row is going upstairs. Really starting to give me the irrits. Seriously. It might be touched. Is it touched, Paul?
I don't think so.
I think it might be, Paul.
It should have been, but I reckon he's folded his fingers and his hand. He's gone limp wrist.
Ben Miller. But you can't tell from that. You can't. It's just guesswork. Those blokes over there, you got it wrong. It's theirs. It touched. I don't know. We're going upstairs. This is the longest quarter in football in history. Imar Insurance are getting banged for their buck, their loyalty program for tradies. You can't tell from that, Paul. That's not what they're looking at. They're in a room with 400 other TVs.
I think it's going to be a goal.
Clap, 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 clap. Get on with it, I say. Seriously, the game is a joke.
But now they're checking for touched off the
boot. Give me a break. That's not what the goal umpire was saying. He was saying was on the line. It's not what happened 40 metres away. It's a goal. I just wasted 2 minutes of my life.
But it's been good comedy, Tim. Some of your best work here on AFL Nation.
Seriously.
And you called it too. West Coast to win. You called it 2 weeks ago.
It's not over yet, Paul. The Tides are right in this.
Oh, West Coast from this position.
Two goals to Petrocelli. Good goal, wasn't it?
Petrocelli two in the quarter.
See, that's the goal of the day. And we spent 2 minutes. So the air gets sucked out of it, Paul. That's my point.
No argument from me.
Elders, you can rely on Elders. 11-1. Wow, when was the last time the Eagles kicked 11 goals? One.
Over to you, Laura Kane and Andrew Dillon. Do something about it this week.
Do it now. Do it now. And a half minutes. This is going to be a 37, 38-minute quarter. Kelly, and it's a lot of stoppages. A lot of kicks. Look out, Jinbi. Broke the tackle. Did well with the left. Got away from Bolton. Up and under kick. Where's Jack Darling? Doesn't mark it. Running back with the flight. Miller's over the footy for the Tigers.
And big Bailey Williams has been brilliant too through the midfield. The ruckman had the number of Nan Curvis so far in this contest.
Nan Curvis. Yo falling over. His hand pass was hot going the other way. And pass out wide. Hunt hasn't had much to do. McIntosh wants the boundary line. Hunt gets the boundary line. That's his safety. That's his friend and will have a throw in. 75 around. Eagles head to the ground. We've got 34 and a half minutes. No, we've had no injury timeout. We haven't had stretches. We haven't gone off for lightning. It's because we've had 75 reviews. 11-1 to 7-7. Eagles up. Kelly, 85 out. Kick smothered. He's gone the fend off. He's gone the fend off the Tiger. Fans unhappy, 55 out. It's good to be back when the Eagles fans are up and about and their team's winning. I reckon they're getting a rough end of the pineapple. Tap down. Yo. Oh, they crushed him. Free kick. Yep, high tackle. And Yo can kick a long ball. He's already kicked one this quarter. He's 50 metres and never even been a 55. And he got the Mark Lacroix about him. He's walking back with his back to the play gun. I ain't passing this for no one.
He's been extraordinary too through the midfield. This will be disposal number 17 in the first half and goal number two. If he can go back and kick it, seven clearances as well. Tim Kelly, second best player on the ground in my opinion. He's got 15 disposals, five clearances. And probably leaving out Jake Waterman, who's got the four goals.
This is no certainty for a goal for DLFC, certainly through science, but Elliot Yeo is known to kick a long ball and gives it everything. It's going to land short. Who flies? Loose ball, goal square. Jack Williams there, they dive in there. Marek is there. Umpire says, I'll ball it up. It came flying out, but the whistle had already gone. It's coming back. So ball up, 11-1-67 to 7-7-49. This quarter has gone 36 minutes. It's got 38 written all over it. And Curvis, kick smothered. Darling, going to be another stoppage and another ball up. So in this quarter, the West Coast Eagles have kicked eight goals. When was the last time they kicked eight straight in the quarter? Shepherding, Bailey Williams free kick. So Bailey Williams is lining up for goal after being a Shepherding free kick. So we take a look at the replay. The Mac family range is back. Bailey Williams. So I've just mozzed him because I've said they kicked eight straight in this quarter. He's bound to miss. He has. So he and Darling have both missed shots from the right-hand goalpost. Should have been a 10-goal turn. 11-2-68 to 7-7-49. This quarter's gone 37 minutes. It could be a 39-minuter. It could be a 30. When was the last time we had a 39-minute quarter and we haven't had a stretcher?
Just need one more review. We'll get there.
Bolton goes short. Get on to Sir Swamp Thing. No tie. No. The game did not stop. Has not stopped for any injury. Oh, drop mark far side. Hand pass. Baker hacks it forward. McGovern kicks it. Tom Cole, look out, Tom. Oh, dear. He marks him. He's under a bit of pressure. Seth Campbell was bearing down on him. Did well, Cole. Can be a bit shaky in those moments. 30 seconds to go. They've got to hold firm here, the Eagles. They lead by 19 points. Kicks to the wing. Juggle mark taken by Nan Curvis. What do the Tigers want to do? They've still got time. It needs to be a mark inside 50 and then the siren. But Barris is in position A. He goes up. He's taken out of the contest and got a free kick for a Shepherd. So that'll be all she wrote. Listen to the crowd. A quarter that produced 8-1 to the West Coast Eagles, and Richmond chimed in with 3-4 of their own. 11-2-68. Bailey Williams and Dusty Martin missed, and Jack Darling missed shots from the goalpost for 1 point, and really, they were sodas. It could have been a whole lot worse for Richmond. But the game's not over. It is absolutely not over. That quarter went 38 minutes and 13 seconds. 11-2-68 to 7-7-49. Jake Waterman's got four and Petrocelli's got two. And the only multiple goal kicker is Shea Bolton for the Tigers. He has been superb. Let's get a breakaway. AFL Nation for the 4-20 Traveller. And the TAC Elders, you can rely on Elders. We'll come back with the halftime floor show. This is AFL Nation. It's the Eagles by 19.
That quarter on AFL Nation was for Elders. Buy your crop protection products at Elders to win.
The game of footy. It's all about interpretation. Like when a well-designed kick dribbles over the boundary line, the crowd roars, deliberate! Well, there's no misinterpreting your intentions when you get hold of a delicious 4-20 king-size sausage roll. This is footy's snack food version of a big barrel straight up the guts. So when you cross that line from hungry to famished, don't waste time dishing off a cute handball. The sausage roll is your route one to goal. 4-20, deliberately delicious.
Hear from the biggest names in sport on SEN.
Drives the field goal right up the lane.
Catch up on all the latest scores and news in the time it takes to get from the car park to the office with SEN's The Day's Play.
Chris Golding, bang!
Our team of expert commentators go over the results, cover the big talking points, plus share the match highlights and big moments.
Goals here to Robinson. Edge to Tonko!
SEN's The Day's Play. thanks to Drinkwise. If you're choosing to have a drink, choose to Drinkwise.
Flat footy moments to avoid this season. The turnstile.
Mate beats mate at the gate. Match day tickets are on the mobile. Lining up to scan through. No! What's happened here? His phone's flat. He can't access the tickets.
Stay charged with a Signet power bank. Compact and lightweight, it fits in your pocket, and you'll never be flat when it's time to tap and go. Signet power banks, available at signet.com, as well as in-store at JB Hi-Fi and other leading retailers.
That roast chicken? Maybe halal. That snack pack? Yep, halal. Dad's investment portfolio. How on earth would you tell? Talk to Hijaz Financial Services. Helping Muslim Australians secure halal super, home loans and investments. Hijaz Financial Services. Definitely halal. HijazFS.com.au.
This information is provided by Hijaz Financial Advisors, Proprietary Limited. AFSL 517686. And Hijaz Islamic Credit Solutions, Proprietary Limited. ACL 480542. And does not take into account your objectives, financial situation or needs.
Hi, Josh Kennedy here. If you're looking to support a 100% Aussie energy retailer that's backed by Snowy Hydro, a leader in renewable energy, and has an amazing team of consultants all based here in Australia, you should give our friends at Red Energy a call today. They're good people, they have competitive rates, and they'll look after you. In fact, tell them I sent you. Call 131 806 or go to redenergy.com.au.
Eligibility, criteria, and conditions apply.
We know you might go to some of the big brands of the mattress world too. That's fair enough. But all we're suggesting is check out the OMF Signature range as well. Or even OMF's Best Value Bed in Box mattresses. Come and have a lie down. Simply see how you feel. And then look at the price. You might just agree that at OMF, we'll make you 100% comfy. OMF.
She's our service. Calling all assistant managers and managers in the trade sector looking for a change. Sheen Panel Service might be exactly what you're looking for. Enjoy perks like great salary, RDOs, ongoing training and support, fully maintained car, employee assistance program, career growth, and so much more. You'll be working with the best because at Sheen Panel Service, we have them. Apply at Sheen Panel Service. Head to our careers page at sheengroup.com.au.
Stylish and sophisticated. Bold and exciting. The first ever Lexus LBX is now available at Lexus of Brighton. A reimagined luxury compact SUV delivering a commanding presence, confidence-inspiring dynamics, and the highly efficient hybrid powertrain that you've come to expect from Lexus. Lexus of Brighton invites you to come and experience the Lexus LBX now. Expect perfection. Experience amazing. Nepean Highway.
LMCT 9897.
You're listening to AFL Nation for 4 and 20. You can't have footy without a 4 and 20 pie.
Maccas, I'm loving it highlights. The Mac family range is back.
West Coast have numbers here. Hand pass Petrucelli got from Brockman. Open forward line, chips over the top. Needs a kind bounce, needs no bounce. He kicks it straight through the middle. Kick by Yo around the corner. Morris, kick a goal, son, it does. Absolutely sensational by Rioli.
The Halftime Floor Show for Choices Flooring. Inspire and visualise with RoomView, our instant room visualiser.
Yeah, absolutely. Discover the power of colour with Spaces for Living Sale. Paul Hazelby, Tim Gossage with you. 11-2-68 to 7-7-49. The Eagles by 19 points. This score of 11-2-68 is the West Coast's biggest halftime score in 3 years. Previous best 11-4-70 against Fremantle in 2021. So That's the biggest since then. Paul Hazelby's with me to go through the categories for MEGT. Let MEGT help you build a winning team. Your power play rankings, Paul, for Red Energy, for 100% Australian electricity and gas.
Been some really good players from both sides. It was all the Tigers, wasn't it, early, particularly in the first 15 minutes of that first quarter. But since then, the Eagles have been irresistible with the way they've played. They've got a bit more speed on the ball. They also started to win the clearance, and they got some good bang from buck from some of those kick-ins as well, scoring two goals in a row, which is quite rare from that part of the ground. But Jake Waterman has been the highest ranked player on the ground. He's got the four goals, some really good contested marks, 74 ranking points. Elliot Yeo, as we've sung his praises throughout the contest, he's had the 17 disposals, 63 points. Toby Nankervis, good battle in the ruck, but he's had 23 hit-outs, a lot of points coming from that, and the 8 disposals, 59. And Shea Bolton, he had the 3 goals early in this contest with 58.
Unmissable moments for Drink Wise. You won't miss a moment if you drink wise.
Well, I came here and I wanted to watch Shea Bolton.
Oh, yeah.
He's delivered. He kicked the 3 goals. Needs a bit more supply now in this contest. Rioli's been good down there, but just some of his work. When there's speed on the ball coming from the corridor and he's one out, very difficult to stop. Brady Hoff's tried really hard. He's had some good moments on him, but there's been times where he's just taken his eye off the ball and also the player with the ball. But we continue to watch that. 3 in the first half. He's going to need to probably kick 6 if the Tigers are to win this.
Choose to drink wise. Your crucial moment for New Farm?
Well, I'm a big believer that when the momentum's going your way, you've got to get separation in the game. We saw it last night with Fremantle. Couldn't get some scoreboard pressure, and the moments are those easy goals. I don't think forwards practice these too often. How often do you actually see them right on the goal line kicking on their left? They always practice from in front, 15, 20, 30, out to 55 metres, but both Williams and Jack Darling missing crucial goals. They should have been taken. Throw that in. All of a sudden, it could have been game over at half time, given the dominance we saw in that quarter.
Exactly right. They were very, very clunky misses. Who's making it look easy? Don't forget, kick off your next painting project with Monarch Painting Made Easy.
Elliot Yeo is making it look easy. 5 disposals in the first quarter. He had 12 in that quarter to finish with 17 for the half. 8 clearances, 2 tackles. It's the Elliot Yeo of old. He's back to his best after missing close to 3 years with osteitis pubis and all other ailments. It's great to see him back firing in the midfield, and what a difference he makes to their team.
Monarch available at Bunnings Warehouse. What was the clanger for Amy? Clangers happen. Lucky you're with Amy.
You've got it, Timmy. You were fired up. It's the extensive review process that we're subjected to right now in the AFL, and I threw it out there. Laura Kane, Andrew Dillon, I know you listen to AFL Nation. Now is the time. Do something this week. Get in a room. Sort it out. There has to be a better way.
Lucky you're with Amy. Who's the player of the first half for TR Group, Commercial Truck and Trailer Rentals and Lease?
So many good players. I like what Tim Kelly did. 15 disposals. Elliot Yeo, so close. But when you have a forward that takes 4 contested marks and kicks 4 goals, that means you're on track for 8. If you can do that in the second half, we must reward those big bags in our game, because the forwards, they often miss out and the midfielders win most of the awards. But it's been Jake Waterman, 4 goals. He's been outstanding so far.
Around the grounds for Chemist Warehouse, a 75-point win to Geelong over North Melbourne, 21-13, 139 to 10-4-64.
Just having a look at the stats, the Tigers had 147 disposals. The West Coast Eagles edged in front that quarter, 158. The clearances, it's been a dominance by West Coast. They're plus 5. The turnovers, though, still 3 more to West Coast, inside 50s, still in favour of the Tigers after a good first quarter. They had 27 for the half, the West Coast Eagles 25, which goes to show they've kicked 11-2 from 25 entries. That's unbelievable efficiency. The marks inside 50 now, after being 6-3 at quarter time, a 10 apiece. So 7 marks inside their forward 50 in that quarter to West Coast.
Dusty Martin, only 7 disposals.
And being used predominantly as a forward. I know with the 2 big forwards out for the Tigers, they need somebody down there, but I would have thought young midfield dominated by the old Bulls, essentially Kelly and Yeo for West Coast, he would have been better served in the midfield.
Jaden Short and Luke Edwards have both been subbed out of the game, replaced by Ryan Marrick and Tyler Sonsi. That was the Choices Flooring Halftime Floor Show. Transform your home with Choices Flooring Sale, offering 30-plus discounted carpet and hard flooring styles for endless design possibilities. Score, 11-2-68 West Coast, their biggest halftime score in 3 years. And the Tigers are 7-7-49. Other winners today, Geelong by 75 over North Melbourne. And the West Coast Eagles waffle team won their first game in 28 games, beating East Fremantle earlier today. And the other scoreline, Melbourne City, 8. Perth Glory, 0. AFL Nation, second half from the West, next.
You're listening to AFL Nation for 4 and 20. You can't have footy without a 4 and 20 pie.
Thanks to Flight Centre, the Melbourne Mavericks are giving one lucky fan the chance to win a massive $10,000 Flight Centre gift voucher to use to build and experience your ultimate holiday. For your chance to win, make sure you fly over to the Melbourne Mavericks home game on April 14 or 27. Support your Mavericks and you'll go into the draw. It's all thanks to Flight Centre. Book with your very own travel expert in store today.
Hi, Josh Kennedy here. Have you received an electricity or gas price increase? Or you're worried about rising energy costs? Give Red Energy a call. Their Aussie-based team will give you a no-obligation energy bill comparison, and you might be surprised by what they have to offer. Plus, Red Energy is owned by Snowy Hydro, a leader in renewable energy. Give 100% Australian-owned Red Energy a call today on 131 806 or visit redenergy.com.au.
Eligibility, criteria and conditions apply.
The game of footy. It's all about interpretation. Like when a well-designed kick dribbles over the boundary line, the crowd roars, "Deliberate!" Well, there's no misinterpreting your intentions when you get hold of a delicious 4 and 20 king-size sausage roll. This is footy's snack food version of a big barrel straight up the guts. So when you cross that line from hungry to famished, don't waste time dishing off a cute handball. The sausage roll is your route one to goal. 4 and 20, deliberately delicious.
If you love chasing, pacing and racing, we've got it all covered on SEN Track. With a stellar lineup of shows round the clock, we've got exactly what you need. Like Giddy Up with Gareth Hall.
Join me for Giddy Up with the biggest news and opinions every morning.
Saturday Trackside.
Here I come, baby. Let down.
And live shows every night.
Are you allergic?
Listen live on SEN Track and the SEN app. SEN Track, your home of chasing, pacing and racing every day of the week.
Flat footy moments to avoid this season. The turnstile.
Mate meets mate at the gate. Match day tickets are on the mobile. Lining up to scan through. No! What's happened here? His phone's flat. He can't access the tickets.
Stay charged with a Signet power bank. Compact and lightweight, it fits in your pocket, and you'll never be flat when it's time to tap and go. Signet power banks, available at signet.com, as well as in-store at JB Hi-Fi and other leading retailers.
Looking for a super fund that is halal and affordable? Get Halal Super from Hijaz Financial Services. We help Australians invest their super while your funds remain true to your values. Hijaz Financial Services, keeping halal super affordable. HijazFS.com.au.
This information is provided by Hijaz Financial Advisors Proprietary Limited, AFSL 517686, and Hijaz Islamic Credit Solutions Proprietary Limited, ACL 480542, and does not take into account your objectives, financial situation or needs.
When you walk into OMF, it's okay to close your eyes. We encourage it, in fact, because all we're suggesting is after you've looked somewhere else, check out our signature range of mattresses or even OMF's best value bed-in box mattresses. Come and have a lie down. Simply see how you feel and then open your eyes and look at the price. You might just see that you'll be 100% comfy.
Sheen Panel Service.
Calling all assistant managers and managers in the trade sector looking for a change. Sheen Panel Service might be exactly what you're looking for. Enjoy perks like great salary, RDOs, ongoing training and support, fully maintained car, employee assistance program, career growth, and so much more. You'll be working with the best because at Sheen Panel Service, we have them. Apply at
Sheen Panel Service.
Head to our careers page at sheengroup.com.au.
You're listening to AFL Nation for 4 and 20. You can't have footy without a 4 and 20 pie.
Welcome back. Both teams on the ground at Optus Stadium. 11-2-68, West Coast 7-7-49. The Tigers get the first four goals of the game. And I can tell you that this has been posted by Sir Swamp Thing, best in the business. The highest opening half of 2024. 18 goals, 9. Beating that in round one of GWS and North Melbourne. So there it is, high scoring footy in the West, 18-9, 117, the combined first half score. Paul Hazeby's with me. This game's not over, Paul. It's all very well for Eagles fans to sit back comfortably and think they're showing signs. I can tell you right now that Ruben Jimby, Chris Klifounis is down there right now as we speak on the boundary line. Chris, he's talking to the trainers right now. He's got this cork in the right leg. What can you see from your vantage point?
Yeah, talking to the trainers, he has looked a little bit uncomfortable ever since he did come back onto the ground. He was never really moving quite right, very ginger all throughout that second quarter. And right now he's surrounded by about four trainers just having a chat. He was doing a lot of work on the bench when he initially came off. And right now just having a chat and feeling around that kind of calf quad area. So we'll keep you up to date, but hopefully he'll be able to run it off in this third quarter.
Yeah, he's got heavy strapping on the right quad.
Yes.
So nowhere near his calf, Chris. I don't know what you're looking at, but I can tell you.
Human biology, not my strong suit, guys.
No, you're 100% right there. So just having a look there. I think you'll just have to push through. They've already activated their sub. And Chris, you talked early also at ground level about the frustration for the West Coast Eagles early doors. How quickly did they change?
Oh boy, did that turn around nice and quick. As the halftime siren went, the entire crowd here at Optus Stadium, standing ovation. And then again, when the Eagles went down the tunnel, 30 seconds later, this little area right beside me, which is where the Eagles run off, the crowd was going absolutely cocoa bananas, as you'd say, Goss. They were up and about, and it's the most energetic I've seen an Eagles crowd in a few years, I'd say.
Thanks to everyone who's texting in too. Donnie and Daryl, Scott, some bloke that's probably not listening because he'll think he's turned over, gone to another channel. Paul Hazeby, what do Richmond have to do? They're the ones that need to find three or four goals to get themselves back in it.
Yeah, they do. And it starts at centre bounce in the contest. We know that. They probably should look to get maybe Dustin Martin back in there. He's only had the seven disposals so far in this game. He's so critical to their chances. They roll the dice and start with Shea Bolton through the midfield. It looks like that is going to be the case. And then just rely on a bit of a makeshift forward line as Dustin Martin makes his way into the forward line. So he won't start in there. But they've just got to rest some of that momentum back. Get on top of the clearances and get the game played in their front half. Get some better supply. Kaczynski had a couple of moments. They'd love a bit more out of him, but it's been about the small forwards. Rioli and also Bolton have been the most dangerous in this contest.
Bolton's now gone forward.
He went to go in the midfield, didn't he?
He certainly did.
Came back and cut back into the forward line.
Certainly did.
So Brady Hoff is that matchup. So it is a young midfield. We know that coming in. We knew that. With Taranto going out. Liam Baker is in there. Jack Graham as well. Elliot Yeo, 17 disposals. Tim Kelly, 15. Baker, 12. Graham, 10. Darling, 10. He's been good, Darling. Marlon Pickett up to 9. Petricelli, Ben Miller, Ryan Mansell, each with the 9 disposals.
Ruben Jimby starting on the bench, boys, and straight onto the bike and pumping those legs.
Getting ready for the Tour de France.
Not ideal, that. If you do have a corky, you prefer to be back out on the ground and try and run through it.
A 19-point deficit for the Tigers to overcome. They do score quickly, the Tigers. Tapped down by Nan Curvis. Graham and Kelly were just holding each other as that ball trickled past them. We have a secondary ball up a little bit closer to the Tigers' end of the ground, still in the centre square. Yeo. Hand pass just got it away, shrugged the shoulders. Got it to Kelly, who got it to Duggan. Chaos ball inside 50. Waterman, little hack forward. Daniel Rioli, hand pass. Miller. Cripps, under pressure. Oh, well done, Darling. Swatted it forward. Noah Long, hand pass back to Darling. Well, the boundary line here, West Coast, I think. Waterman, Miller, and the ball goes over. That's a win for both teams there. That was a hot footy. In the end, we get the boundary throw in, 45 out Eagles into the ground.
Reading the taps really well, Tim Kelly and Elliot Yeo. Now Curvis dominating the hit-outs. Often they're getting first possession.
AFL Nation for the 4-20 sausage roll and the TAC. Police can be anywhere, anytime. A message from the TAC. Darling in the role of ruck. Tap down. Back to Darling again. It was not the hand pass. It got lucky, I think. Should have been a free kick for holding the ball. We'll have another ball up, though. 35 out in the left forward pocket for the Eagles.
It's never been an instinctive handballer, Jack Darling. It's get the ball, hold it, and then make the decision.
We change to the halftime score for Host Plus. There's Darling again in the ruck. Noah Long's involved. Cripps is involved. Burrows a ball forward, taken coming back the other way by Daniel Rioli. And the Eagles forcing it forward, now 25 metres around from goal. Still in the left forward pocket. Darling again rucking. Nan Curvis, size wins out. Taken by Yo, back feet. Oh, taken Harley Reid, zigs and zags again. Hair pass, back feet towards Kelly. Kick with the right around the corner. Needs a Shepherd, just to the right. Harley Reid got one across the chops, got unlucky. Probably could have got a free inside there. First quarter, first score of the quarter, should I say, was a point. Host Plus has been named Money Magazine's best super fund for 2024. That's a plus. Issued by Host Plus Pty Limited. Check the PDS and TMD at hostplus.com.au. So Miller started really strongly, although this time his wide kick is going to pitch. Tap down Hoff, the foul, Hunt, Long, hacks it forward, pitch and bounce. It was always going to go over the top of those players. Waterman, little deft touch going back the other way. Strong tackle. No prior, we're going to have a ball up. The Eagles inside 50 are locking this ball in. Tigers are under enormous pressure early.
Haven't done that too often, have they, to start this season? They get a chance to rest in defence. They've got numbers back. Spare player in McGovern, and that's not ideal for the Tigers.
Darling got pushed out, didn't get a free. Taken by Nan Curvis, up and under. Who's going to stand underneath that? Duggan almost marked it. Well done, though, by Morris Rioli. Forced the spoil. Hacked forward by Jack Graham. Pitching ball to the wing. Barris Lafau taps it back inside. Bolton's coming one way. McGovern's coming the other. Oh, Bolton, simply brilliant. Tapped it to his own advantage. Tapped it twice. Left it behind on this occasion. Witherden now goes wide, and Hunt marks just inside the boundary line. Interchange wing. Goes short down the line. Reid demands the footy. He's got Noah Long short. Does that make sense? In the middle, standing with his arms up, is Witherden. He's allowed to play on here, Reid. Kicks it long inside 50. Bailey Williams getting back, but didn't read it all well. Punched down by Young. Coming back the other way, Baker. Oh, got a whack across the head. Should have got a free. Come back to Yo. Snaps on goal. Needs a Shepherd. And gets that Shepherd. Same goal up prior, but this time he doesn't go upstairs. Across the chops. In the end, Yo kicks the goal. It's a beauty. It's a great start to the turn for the Eagles. Yo gets his second, and West Coast have their biggest lead in the game. 12-3. Yeah, Yo with the left arm. Baker should have got a free. 7-7, 49, 26 points to margin. Unlucky the Tigers.
It's elite awareness. There's not too many players in the competition that can get that sort of leverage from a kick. Didn't need too many steps. Just inside the 50. Elliot Yo continues on with his great day. Has he gone past Waterman now as the best player on the ground? He's getting closer. But they get reward for effort. Ball in the front half, set up the wall, repeat entries, and you get a goal from a stoppage.
Host Plus, Eagles in front by 26 points. Their biggest lead in the game. And Baker, very unlucky. Did get one across the chops. Accidental it may have been, but still should have been a free. Harley Reid. Everyone went right. And Harley said, I'll go left then. Then kicks it long. Here comes the Waterman lead. Got pushed out. Miller took the mark. And Price says, fair play.
He just runs straight, doesn't he? Harley Reid. A lot of players. Handball back.
Called to play on now, Miller. Short to Daniel Rioli. Inside his defensive 50. 12-3. 7-7.
Dustin Martin went into that centre bounce. Got the first possession, but a little fumble. He just doesn't look quite right today, Dustin.
Daniel Rioli to the wing. Big flight. Barris doesn't mark it. Loose ball, Reid. He goes to ground. There's over it now, Vlosten coming through Dow. Hand pass, Morris Rioli. Got through one tackle. Witherden stood up in it and then looks up and says, which way will I go? Pulls the kick beautifully. Good vision. Kelly's got long short if he wants to go to him. I've said that three times. It still doesn't make sense. Cripps is the option this time. Lace out Waterman. Long comes off the ground, and Jake Waterman lining up for five goals. It was the last time he kicked five in a game. Jake Waterman.
He's just looked like a true full forward today, hasn't he?
Quick delivery, as you said, repeat entries. Jimby now limps his way onto the ground. He's worth nothing sitting on the bench. Might as well get something out of him. Waterman lines up for goal five. Checked his kick when he put it through. He's missed to the right. Six gone, 12-4, 76, 7-7, 49. Thanks to Host Plus.
Door still ajar, isn't it, for the Tigers?
Yes.
West Coast have missed some chances. Good work there by Witherden, though, going against the traffic, back into the side. Kicking's been probably the knock on his game and found Tim Kelly to set up that goal. As you see, a good mark over on the far side from Josh Rotham. Looks for his options and plays fires on. Back into the 50.
Gets away from Sonsi. Big fly. Marrick barely called his name since subbing in. Hand pass back now from Brockman. Look out, Reed. Just got scragged when he's kicked it. It was a good chase down tackle from behind. The mark's been taken by Miller. Goes across his own goal face. This defence is under enormous pressure. Broad has it. Back pocket. Eagles are closing all the outlets. 12-4, 7-7. Just gets it inside the boundary line. Vlosten took a great mark earlier. 27 points the margin. Biggest lead in the game for the Eagles. Change of direction. Shows a bit of the footy. Oh, Brockman. Across. Mark's been taken. Back pocket. They go wide here, the Tigers. But Rotham gathers. Needs to hand pass it away. He does. Darling puts his backside in. Taken to ground by the picket tackle. No prior. They're over the footy. And the umpire again lurks and says, I'll ball it up. Eagles probably got away with one right there. Right half forward, 12-4, 76, 7-7, 49 for Host Plus. Paul Hasby's our expert for MEGT, Australia's Apprenticeship Experts.
Good tackle there from Pickett because they had the plus one at ground level, just had to keep the ball in, and he did that. Jack Darling couldn't break the tackle.
McCall have stood up in that tackle too. And coming back the other way was Dow, and he's taken Chesser and had another ball up far side. Kaczynski rucking. Reed fended off Dusty. Guess what? Then got it out. Umpire paid advantage free. Got to Chesser inside 50. Waterman now got it again in front of Tyler Young. His stretch and reach has been extreme. And this is his pocket. I dare say it. He likes this pocket. For whatever reason, this is not normally a problem. Right forward pocket, 30 metres out. 60-degree angle. Jake Waterman, for the second time in the quarter, lining up for goal number five.
You rarely see this sort of dominance in this day and age from a key forward, taking so many contested marks. I reckon that's number five inside the forward 50. Going back for goal number five. Just clunking those balls every time they fall into his hands.
Waterman, he loves this spot on the ground. Not today, he doesn't. Loose ball, Marrick. Back feeds now. Hand pass was hot towards Hunt. Flicks it back to Jack Williams. Has a voice out back. Tom Cole took a long time. You can see that was going to be smothered before Tom did. That's for sure and certain. Then he's dropped it. Now he's fallen over. And the ball comes off McGovern and goes over the line. Tom Cole, you know that's going to happen with Tom. He allows, it's such an obvious kick, he allows the opposition to smother the footy. It happens far too often for Tommy.
He's been a regular for a long time when he's been fit, Tom Cole. But as they evolve, definitely going to be more pressure on spots in the team.
Great give there by Martin to Baker. Two of their toughest. They combine. McGovern on hands and knees. Went to go back. Oh, heard a voice out wide. It was Hunt. It was clever by McGovern. Hunt now kicks down the line. Jack Williams is in pretty good position here. Getting back was Broad. Darling's been very handy today. Close to the line. They work it over. And as the umpire see it, he says that was okay. Tom Brown was backpedalling, so we have another throw in. Again, another forward entry, 55 metres out.
Just looks like he's got his work rate back and his agility back, Jack Darling. That's what made him such a good player when he first entered the competition.
55 out, Eagles in, but they've got to get bang for their buck. Here's Tom Cole, this time through the ball, straight onto the boot. He kicked it out of bounds. Another throw in, 25 out, Eagles into the ground. We've gone 10 minutes in the quarter. AFL Nation for the 4-20 sausage roll and Host Plus. It is the Eagles by 27 points as Bailey Williams comes off for a well-deserved break. We have a throw in. Tap down Darling. Kelly, front of the stoppage. Little flick to Yo, boundary line. Quick kick through the congestion. Waterman again. He's marked it again, Waterman. This time alongside the left-hand behind post. I was going to say this is his best part of the ground, but I don't want to moz him. But he likes to kick goals in this pocket too.
9 inside 50s to 0 so far in this game, in this quarter. Well on top, the West Coast Eagles. He needs to go back and kick this, Jack Waterman, for all the dominance they've had.
Steps to the right and bends to his fifth. Jake Waterman is playing the best game of his career. And the Eagles are out to a 33-point lead. 12, make that 13-4-82 to 7-7-49. In this quarter, the Eagles have added 2 goals to 2. The Tigers have not added to their score. Paul Hazelby.
It's really good to see, isn't it, Jake Waterman, 5 goals. He's had to work really hard, of course, son of a gun. Chris Waterman, premiership player for the West Coast Eagles, had to fight for his spot. He was always that third or fourth wheel, not deemed tall enough to take over that position. You know, I think he contemplated leaving at one point. He got ill last year, back to full fitness, massive pre-season. And as I said coming in, I thought he was the key player. It's now his forward line. He's the number one forward in their team. And he's delivered today, and the supply's been pretty handy too.
On the back of no Oscar Allen. Pressure bell goes off Jack Darling days like today when he doesn't have to be the main man. Flick up was again by Yo. This time Jack Williams barrels it inside 50. Waterman underneath it. Doesn't mark on this occasion. Jindy got an ugly bounce. Waterman just says, get out of my way. Give me the footy. Quick kick by Darling off the left. Little pitching ball. No! They all stood back and waited for it. And the mark's been taken by Crick. 40 metres out directly in front. He was unlikely to mark it. Two Tigers had a conversation. Neither of them went for it. And Jamie Cripps is lining up for goal.
It's fallen to pieces, hasn't it, for the Tigers? Just looking at each other. Experienced player there too in Nick Boston. Just the weight of numbers. That's 10 inside 50s to 0 this quarter. Very hard to see the Tigers coming back from this position. Brilliant early. 4 early goals. It's basically been 13-3 since.
Kicked a goal from a similar range at the other end in the last quarter. Cripps directly in front. Liked it as soon as he kicked it. Held the hand up after he dropped the ball to his boot. He does things so well and so efficiently, does Jamie Cripps. And it's looking ugly for the Tigers. 14-4-88 to 7-7-49. Thanks to Host Plus. Here's Paul Hazelby. He's our expert. MEGT.
They've been a while for the West Coast Eagles, we know that, but right now they look like they are the winners from a long way out. 14-4, brilliant execution of their goal kicking, but again it's coming from the centre bounce. Elliot Yeo, Tim Kelly, Harley Reid's been in there, now got young Jack Williams as their ruck with Bailey Williams taking a break. Inexperienced midfield right now. Thompson Dow in there, Bolton goes back in for the Tigers. I need to show some fight.
Jack Williams, taken now by Jinby. Inside the left, punched away by Ralph Smith. Daniel Rioli gathers, runs hard, has a bounce, but his options are bereft. Has a third bounce, but he's run himself right to the boundary line. And then Chester pressured him over. He just had nothing to kick to. He was trying to get something. He was trying to get something, and it just didn't happen for him.
Haven't now, seen much of him today, Daniel Rioli.
Daniel Rioli and Marek, while all that's going on, Waterman got an arm chop and didn't get a free, and the ball goes over the line now to play and will have a throw in.
Again, though, he clunked it. It was in the hands. Ben Miller winning that contest, but he's been well on top.
14-4 to 7-7. 3 goals, 2 to no score in 15 minutes of this quarter for Host Plus. And the 4-20 sausage roll. Tigers have got to find something. Chesser, good smother, Bolton. Good recovery, Chesser. Bounce back in his arms. Kelly, half forward. Kicks it long to the goal square. Brockman, Waterman, free kick, Waterman! When you're hot, you're hot. Ben Miller started in a blaze of glory. And now he's completely frustrated. And Waterman's lining up for goal number 6.
Yep, he's fearsome of Jake Waterman right now. Gave away the free kick, grabbed the arm. Another quick entry though, goodbye Campbell Chester. Didn't get it originally back into the corridor, but Tim Kelly was waiting. And if you just get that extra depth and run towards the 50, get it in longer inside 20 metres, that's where defenders make the most mistakes.
He's already got a career high 5. He's now got a career high 6. Jake the Snake Waterman is the Tigers' poison. This 15-4-94
7.49. Percentage becomes important now here for the West Coast Eagles. We know they've got a few. They can get closer back to equilibrium. And, of course, trying to get off the bottom of the ladder. But if they continue like we're seeing today, we've got the Derby next week. All of a sudden, a bit more spice going into that game. Their senior players have stood up all year, but some of those younger players coming on for the party now as well. Just to have some key forwards. They're competing, and they've got that in Jack Darling. They've got that in Jake Waterman. And one day soon, Oscar Allen will be back. So they're looking a bit different all of a sudden for the West Coast Eagles.
And Curvis wins it to the backside. Graham receives it from Bolton. Long kick, rare inside 50. Coming out, good mark. Kosicki under heaps of pressure. Marks at 55 out from goal. Now being dragged back, Rotham to the 50. Former Hawk, not confident. He goes wide to the pocket. Just straight over the head of Bolton, who gave up on it. And the ball goes over in front of Hoff, and they have a throw in. 20 metres around, Tigers into the ground. Rare time in this quarter. We've gone 17 minutes, 7-7-49 to 15-4-94. Massive 45-point lead to West Coast. And Curvis to the back. Jinby just gets ball to, boot to ball. Marrick was good. Strong tackle on Reed. They dive on top of him, going nowhere for a ball up 60 metres out for goal. Seth Campbell was doing the tackling for the Tigers. Reed again gathers from a stoppage, has a bounce, hand passes to the outside, Marrick, Yo to the inside, hand pass to Reed, doesn't quite get there, and that's almost out of bounds on the foot. It's a free kick. It's coming
going
back
to West Coast, Harley Reed.
Yeah, it might have been a free kick behind play. He needs to come off, Harley Reed. He looks tight. 15-4 to 7-7, so still no score in this quarter. As opposed to the Eagles kicking 4 goals, 2. Long kick, Reed. Jack Williams almost marks it one-handed. Hand pass back, Broad. Daniel Rioli feigns it and then runs across to Broad. He's looking for people to come at him. Forced to go wide. No mark. West Coasters have numbers. Tom Cole does a 360 and chips around and kicks it on the line. Just marked by Long. Good kick in the end by Cole.
Waterman, excellent covering of the exits.
Waterman wants it. Mark Darling, what a beauty. Right up alongside him was Tyler Young. That is huge. And Jack Darling, too often the whipping boy for the team when they're not winning, but today he can hold his head up high. He's found a bit of the old Jack Darling form.
Needs to cash in with the bag too. He's got the one goal, should have two. Just an easy one from the pocket.
13 disposals. It's been a long time since Jack's had 13 disposals. We'll check that one. Terrible kick by Jack. Again, he just... Oh, here we go. Here we go. I'm going up for another look. Imar Insurance, the shed. Imar's loyalty program. Replay. Score is a mark. No, and that's a point. It's a point. Ball umpire terribly out of position. He was behind the ball rather than on the line. So it's a point. 15-5 to 7-7. 20 gone. Thanks to Host Plus. West Coast cribbing up to 100. Derby here next week. Right down the middle goes the kick. Comes to the back. West Coast have numbers again. Witherden did really well. The late inclusion. That's not a great kick, though. With the outside showing a bit of it, though. Miller marks it. Lucky he didn't get 50 metres against Marrick for trying to just knock the ball out of his hands. That's close to the boundary line. Just inside. Campbell goes short. Kick was hot. Way too hot. Baker, he's tackled strongly. Jimby doesn't let too many go. We have a ball up left half forward. So, again, even the simple skills seem to have evaded the Tigers at this time. AFL Nation for the 4-20 sausage roll, the TAC and Host Plus. Harley Reid gets away one, does a fend off tackle, and then Yo's taken across the line. He is excited.
He is.
He's good to watch, is he? because he's going to take the game on.
He knows where the space is. So he gets the ball, where's the space, gets some speed up. Don't argue to Nant Gervis, who's got long arms himself. He's a big lad. Made him look silly a couple of times today.
Jack Williams has made him look silly too in the ruck contest. Good, took it out of the air. Big fly, Darling. Loose ball. Marrick is there. Can flick it back to Chesser if he gets it. They're good mates. Chesser got dumped into the ground. Was he taken high? No, according to the umpire. We've got ball up 25 out. Again, they're doing all the attacking. Still plenty of time. That last quarter went 38 minutes and 19 seconds, believe it or not.
Elliot Yeo takes a break for Tim Kelly. Been enormous, those two. 23 and 20 disposals.
Stats thanks to the team at Hijaz Halal Financial Services. Free kick, West Coast for a hole. Cripps, I think, getting up. Right forward pocket.
16 disposals now for Harley Reid.
They've done a lot of attacking, haven't they? They've lived in their front half. I'd love to know what the inside 50 count is this quarter, or if not for the game, if we can, Paul. Hijaz Halal Financial Services. This has been a very big quarter for the West Coast Eagles.
-28, and at half time it was 27-25. So they've had three, the Tigers.
Waterman, Cripps. Where is Waterman? Loose ball, Hunt. Still in, and eventually it goes through for a minor score. 15-6, 96-7, 7:49. Jack Darling has had 13 disposals in this game. 7 kicks, 4 marks, only kicked the 1 goal. His career high is 17 disposals in a game.
15-3 inside 50s this quarter.
15-3, and the 3 inside for Richmond have been shallow, just on the 50, haven't they? Barely made it deep at all. They haven't hit the scoreboard. Short to Ralph Smith. Can't get out of their back half. West Coast need to put one more on the board, it would say, to really take any hope out of the equation for Richmond. Barris haven't had much to do down back in this quarter. Hand pass back in. They got it away. Mansell got it down. There's the mark taken. Sonsi goes into the pocket. And there is quick transference of play. And Bolton has marked it. He will straighten up and go short. Dusty Martin has marked.
Been super quiet, Dustin Martin.
You believe one of the best players you've ever seen.
Yep.
Spoke about that on radio on Friday. One of the bona fide superstars of the game. It really should be like shelling peas for a player of his class. Escapes it home. First score. It took 24 minutes. Is there a little light at the end of the tunnel? West Coast did a lot of the attacking. Couldn't quite put the foot on the throat about the last 5 or 6 forward entries. 15-6, 96. To 8-7, 55, margin 39 points, make that 41 points, thanks to Host Plus, Paul Hazelby.
9 disposals and a goal for Dustin Martin. Been sharing the time through the midfield and also at the centre bounce. He just doesn't look completely 100% fit to me. And there were some rumours throughout the week about his future. But if he was 100% fit, I reckon the midfield today, on the back of what we saw last week, 30 disposals from Dustin Martin. Tigers were going to win this game. They had to find something through the midfield. Hasn't been the case. They've had a few guys toil away.
Can they get another one? Can they just give themselves a little sniff of hope? Back, it was a bad bounce by umpire Futter, will now ball it up and reset. The Eagles wouldn't want to take their foot right off the gas, because all of a sudden Richmond will think they've got a sniffing chance here at three-quarter time. If they go back-to-back, they get goals quickly. Here's Nan Curvis. He could be the one who just provides the impetus. Reid flicks it over the top to Chesser. Got Kelly in assistance. Down the line, Waterman. Reid again. Hand pass to the outside. Chesser comes back inboard. Reid got dumped. Taken by Duggan. Big fly. Marrick is caught at the back. No mark taken. Waterman, Marrick. They dive on it now, the Tigers. Going nowhere. Another ball up. Brown was underneath that pack. Another ball up, 55 out.
PB for Harley Reid. Up to 18 now. Equals the PB.
Tap down. Nan Curvis. All of a sudden, Richmond, I reckon, are feeling like sudden West Coast might have fired their best shot. Dow over the top. Baker was falling over when he hand-passed it over his head. Coming back the other way, West Coast, they raffle it, quick hands. Petrocelli got it from Reed. Mark taken by Marek, he showed it a bit of a footy in front of Roskin. On the forward, Sinar forward true. He wants players to run for him outside. Harley Reed offers short. Marek will go there just. Doesn't travel the required distance, so he has to go the fend off. Just got a hand pass away. Here comes Tom Cole. Tom Cole closes on 50. Tom Cole has kicked the goal! Tom Cole has kicked the goal! And the goal umpire doesn't know which side of the bloody post it went! It's the same bloke at the other end! He's got sunnies on and everything! He's not sure! He doesn't know whether it's to the left of the post or the right of the post! He's unsure! He thinks it's the post. He thinks it might have hit the post. It went on the wrong side of the post. It's a point. Yes. But he should have called it because he's in the wrong spot and he's wearing sunnies. And it's driving me absolutely bananas. I'm not coming to the footy again. I'm done. 15-7, 97 to 8-7, 55. Same goal umpire. He's driving me bonkers, Paul.
Got the right outcome in the end. Tom Cole didn't celebrate like he should have had it been a goal from a half-back flank. We know they don't get too many. But it is hard work. They're bereft of confidence, aren't they, the goal umpires? Not making a decision and not getting in the right
position. Get
positions.
Two of them at each end. Do two games a weekend. It's not that hard. You're not running for a marathon. You're standing on your bloody haunches. You're standing on your heels watching a game of footy. There's blokes doing it, drinking turds, doing the same thing, drink-wise. Post plus 15-7 to 8-7, 97-55. Two goal umpires, each end, none of this would be an issue. Reed, hand pass big, long, running. Here's Tom, he says, I've done it once, I'm going to do it again. There's the kick to Brockman who marks it. Barely called his name in the fluoro green boots. You've got to wear boots like that, you've got to do something, and Tyler Brockman will line up for goal and has a chance to put the Eagles into the triple figures. And they've been trying to do that for the last seven times inside 50.
They'd love to get him into some form. He's been pretty quiet, but recruited to the club from the Hawks. You know he can kick a goal. 23 goals across his career from the 30 games. Still very young, only 21.
Brockman. Close to the man on the mark. Way too close to the man on the mark. Fifteen-nine, ninety-nine. 15-8, 98. 8-7, 55 it is. 43 points the margin. Gee, they've done a lot of attacking and haven't been able to hit the big opening in the last 10 or so minutes.
Been their best quarter inside 50-wise. Still really good efficiency.
Four goals, six they've kicked to one goal. Should have easily been 6-4, if not 7-3. There's the kick down the line. McGovern being held by the jumper. Should get a free. Umpire didn't see it. Hand pass over the top by Mansell was good. Coming one way. A beautiful hat forward by Kaczynski. Bolton is classy. Got pushed when he kicked it around the corner. LaFau marks in the pocket. Brilliant stuff by Bolton. Jim McGovern was unlucky not to get a free kick.
He's classy, isn't he, Bolton? Oh. Just to get that purchase on the ball. So most good. People, when you're getting pushed into the boundary like that, don't get the right position on the ball. We found LaFau. Been impressed with LaFau. He's tried hard today. He'll improve with a couple of the other forwards around him.
He's going to kick a banana. He's hit the post three quarters of the way up. Why not? 8-8, 56 to 15-8, 98. Margin back to 42 BPs this thing. Good on your BP. You're a good man. The back pocket with Witherden and came in as a late change for Jamieson. Kicks to the wing. Bailey Williams up. Good mark. Not pay. Unlucky. Oh, gee. Noah Long got off. Yeah, and free kick. McIntosh was tough. Long got underneath the bat. Closing seconds of the quarter. Thanks to Host Plus. 15-8, 98 to 8-8, 56. Short to Duggan. They're going to run it down. As Peter Staples, who's holding signs up, is telling us that we're in the last 30 seconds of the quarter. I don't want to give up another one. McGovern marks. Five goals to Jake Waterman, two to Petricelli, two to Yo, three to Bolton. They are the multiple goal kickers. Yo flies, no mark taken. Siren's going to sound shortly. Tapped down by Young. Siren sounds. And West Coast didn't get true bang for their buck, but they extended their lead. 15-8-98 to 8-8-56. Waterman has five. Cripps, Petricelli and Yo two apiece. Shea Bolton trying to do his best to keep the Tigers in it. 75 points Geelong over North Melbourne. This is AFL Nation for the 4-20 sausage roll, the TAC and Host Plus.
You're listening to AFL Nation for 4-20. You can't have footy without a 4-20 pie.
The Sounding Board with Craig Hutchison and Damien Barrett. It's sport, it's the media, it's talking about the issues that matter.
Well, that's the other thing with Luke, and I say this with a smile. Very difficult to be smashed in a popularity contest with Kane Corns. Like, have you actually set out to achieve that? Yeah, that was actually your aspiration. It's pretty hard to do, right?
Well, see, I don't follow and read people's comments and comments on articles and postings. So is that the way it went, did it?
Oh, I would interpret it as an overwhelming support of Kane and pardon the pun, in the boxing week, a knockout punch. And I guess a little bit of irony of Luke, I guess, accusing Kane of what he was doing to him at the same time. So on the other hand, though, I have a very liberal view of these things, don't I? I like the fact that Luke voiced his opinion. Yeah. I think it's great that he's prepared to say it. That was his view. Obviously, I disagree with it. But, you know, you shouldn't take things personally.
The Sounding Board podcast with Hutchie and Damo. Thanks to Drinkwise. If you're choosing to have a drink, choose to Drinkwise.
Flat footy moments to avoid this season. The turnstile.
Mate beats mate at the gate. Match day tickets are on the mobile. Lining up to scan through. No! What's happened here? His phone's flat. He can't access the tickets.
Stay charged with a Signet power bank. Compact and lightweight, it fits in your pocket, and you'll never be flat when it's time to tap and go. Signet power banks, available at signet.com, as well as in-store at JB Hi-Fi and other leading retailers.
That roast chicken, maybe halal. That snack pack, yep, halal. Dad's investment portfolio, how on earth would you tell? Talk to Hijaz Financial Services, helping Muslim Australians secure halal super, home loans and investments. Hijaz Financial Services, definitely halal. Hijazfs.com.au.
This information is provided by Hijaz Financial Advisors, PTY LTD, AFSL 517686 and Hijaz Islamic Credit Solutions, PTY LTD, ACL 480542 and does not take into account your objectives, financial situation or needs.
The game of footy, it's all about interpretation. Like when a well-designed kick dribbles over the boundary line, the crowd roars, deliberate! Well, there's no misinterpreting your intentions when you get hold of a delicious 4-20 king-size sausage roll. This is footy's snack food version of a big barrel straight up the guts. So when you cross that line from hungry to famished, don't waste time dishing off a cute handball. The sausage roll is your route one to goal. 4-20, deliberately delicious.
Hi, Josh Kennedy here. If you're looking to support a 100% Aussie energy retailer that's backed by Snowy Hydro, a leader in renewable energy, and has an amazing team of consultants all based here in Australia, you should give our friends at Red Energy a call today. They're good people, they have competitive rates, and they'll look after you. In fact, tell them I sent you. Call 131 806 or go to redenergy.com.au.
Eligibility, criteria, and conditions apply.
We know you might go to some of the big brands of the mattress world too. That's fair enough. But all we're suggesting is check out the OMF Signature range as well. Or even OMF's Best Value Bed in Box mattresses. Come and have a lie down. Simply see how you feel. And then look at the price. You might just agree that at OMF, we'll make you 100% comfy.
Stylish and sophisticated. Bold and exciting. The first ever Lexus LBX is now available at Lexus of Brighton. A reimagined luxury compact SUV delivering a commanding presence, confidence-inspiring dynamics, and the highly efficient hybrid powertrain that you've come to expect from Lexus. Lexus of Brighton invites you to come and experience the Lexus LBX now. Expect perfection. Experience amazing. Nepean Highway.
LMCT 9897.
You're listening to AFL Nation for 4 and 20. You can't have footy without a 4 and 20 pie. Maccas, I'm loving it. Highlights. The Mac family range is back.
Coming back the other way, Baker. Oh, got a whack across the head. Should have got a free. Come back to Yo. Snapped on goal. Needs a Shepherd. And gets that Shepherd. And bends to his fifth. Jake Waterman is playing the best game of his career. Kicks it long to the goal square. Brockman, Waterman, free kick, Waterman. He's already got a career high five. He's now got a career high six. Jake the Snake Waterman is the Tigers' poison. The Maccas, the Mac family range is back. AFL Nation for 4 and 20 pies. Paul Hazelby, it is a 42-point lead to West Coast going into the final quarter.
Yeah, it is, and they were dominant, weren't they, in that third quarter. Probably didn't get the full bang for buck, but it's now tough for the Tigers. They just look like they don't have enough guns through that midfield to hold sway and get ascendancy and dominate that inside 50 count in this last quarter. The West Coast Eagles, though, we know it's been a while. Haven't been a winning team for a long time and had that culture, but they need to put the Tigers away right now.
So it is all to do for the Eagles. First and foremost, to win the game, then keep an eye on percentage. The little give to Reed, fend off one, hand pass back to Bailey Williams off a standing start. First inside 50 to the Eagles. Who leads Darling? Doesn't take the mark. Ball spills. Daniel Rioni picks it up, ran into an absolute train, got one high. It's a free kick. Tried hard. Tried hard, Daniel Rioni, trying to get something happening from halfback.
Even Elliot, yo, the spread from the centre bounce started in there. And he was there to try and make that tackle.
A call fell over. Hunt takes the mark. Juggling mark. He's going to come back in with some interest here. Jaden Hunt. Darling, Yo, Kelly doesn't mark it. Loose ball. Tackle and they go to ground.
Not renowned for his high marking there, Tim Kelly, but he was in position A. Went up. Put the knee up, but just, you can see some players, they just don't have that capacity.
The Eagles have been flirting with 100 points in this game. In that last quarter in particular, had plenty of chances. Bolton runs the ball away. Miller flares it wide to Ralph Smith. AFL Nation for 4 and 20 pies and the TAC. Police can be anywhere, anytime. A message from the TAC. Ralph Smith called to play on. Kicks it long into the wind, into the sun, should I say. There's a hold. It's a West Coast free.
Hasn't had to do too much today, Jeremy McGovern. Tigers have tried to bring the ball in with speed, smaller forward line. Haven't really bombed away, which is his strong suit. Hasn't needed to do too much, which is good.
Waterman, a long way down, takes the mark. Inside 50. Mark's been taken by Nan Kerr. Pretty pedestrian stuff to start the quarter.
Elliot Yo, 23 disposals. Harley Reid's up to 22. Tim Kelly, 22. The big three there for West Coast. Baker, 16. Miller, 15. Vlosten, Duggan, Darling and Bolton each with 14.
The foul's got out in the back. He's taken the mark. Directly in front on the quick outlet. So not what the Eagles have liked. The Eagles have improved their percentage by, I think, 14% in this game, and they've jumped two spots, leaving North Melbourne on the bottom, Hawthorn second bottom, and the Eagles are now percentage behind Richmond in 16th.
Been impressed with this kid. Hasn't played too much footy, but he's just, he's got good awareness, good game sense.
It's tough.
And has a crack too.
He kicks the goal. So much needed goal. Lafau gets his second to become the second multiple goal kicker for the Tigers. Bolton's got three, Lafau's got two. This is the start that Richmond won, and all of a sudden the West Coast Eagles would just be thinking to themselves, it's not over yet, boys. 9-8, 62 to 15-8, 98 as Dusty Martin speaks to the group for Tyre Power, your trusted tyre experts. They are Australia's biggest independent tyre retailer. Here's Paul Hazelby.
Powerful too. Nice kick, good set shot routine. Of course, a rugby background. Just got out the back on the West Coast Eagles, who got opened up through the mid part of the field. Has to be now for the Tigers. Bolton goes in. Baker's there. Thompson down.
just got to sow the seed of doubt in the Eagles' head. They don't win many games, West Coast, but surely a seven-goal buffer at three-quarter time. They can't get beaten from here. But Richmond is a high tackle, another one now to the Tigers. So all of a sudden you hear the groans of the crowd. Big crowd in. They feel it. Hadn't much to cheer about over a long period of time. The kick was too hot and Kelly roved it. And then has a bounce. Kelly can go short to Waterman with the outside of the right boot. He waited for it, Waterman. Coming hard the other way. Got him. Great tackle and chase. Not rewarded. And now they get a free kick for a push in the back. Byron McGuinness is inexperienced. He's having a moment. Baker got the freeze against Chesser for a push in the back. I reckon the push in the back was there, but also I think the holding the ball against Miller was there earlier. So Richmond get the good rub of the green. They go short to Dusty Martin. So all of a sudden, crowd on edge. Next goal will be crucial. McGovern won't mark it. Here is the foul. Takes on Duggan. Gets past him, throws it on the boot. Danger ball to the pocket. Through for minor score and out of bounds on the full. Goal umpire was unsure. He needed the boundary umpire to come in and help him out. And we'll get a resultant free kick as we take a look at the big fend off. Duggan put on the deck. We take a look at the replay right there. To Witherden. Eagles have still got to win the game. Long kick out of the defensive 50. Bailey Williams up. Nankervis there. It's going to come back as a free kick. It's going to Jack Williams at the front of the pack. As a runner outside in the skipper Duggan. He goes short to Petrocelli. They should play on, sure. There's no one on the mark, Jack.
And they had the plus one, too. Get the chest up.
See. Sun was in his eyes. Get down to Chris Clafounis in a moment. Tell us what's happening on the bench. Ruben Jimmy's about to check in. Petrocelli kicks on the far wing, inside 50. No mark taken. Ball goes close to the line. Pickett's been quiet. Ball goes over. One of a throw in. Let's go down to Chris Clafounis on the boundary line. Thanks to Spitwater Tough and Ready. High pressure cleaners, tools, not toys.
Watch this face on Ruben Jimby. I'm not sure he will be. He's moving very, very gingerly after he got off the bike. But
the crowd, Chris,
we'll see.
The crowd.
47,665 for turnout. This game.
Good turnout.
Very good. Ryan Marrick does look like he's about to come on. But yeah, Ruben Jimby, just been watching him for the last few minutes and he's been getting a lot of treatment, a lot of massages and on the bike for a while and moving with great difficulty, it looks like. So we'll see.
Righty, we'll find out whether he's right for the Derby next week. Fremantle arriving home after a winless trip to Adelaide. Bailey Williams into the pocket looking for Darling. Don't know what that was all about. That's so obvious to kick into the pocket. Not really a winning spot right there. 15-8-98-9-8-62. Pretty pedestrian stuff this last 7 minutes of the quarter. Thanks to Tyre Power, your trusted tyre experts, Paul Haseby. West Coast need one goal to get the ton. Probably ice the game completely. Hand pass, Baker. Graham. Getting across Williams. There's a free. It's going Richmond's way. Kaczynski. Against Rotham. Short kick. Flick up was good. Hand pass through. Graham. All happening on the far wing. Hand pass over the head. Good knockout there by Duggan. Kelly. Darling wanted it deep. He pulled up on that too, Darling. Throwing his arms, not happy with the delivery. He might actually get lucky again because Kelly's going to get a second go at it. And here he is, Darling, too. Doesn't mark it this time. They come out hard and spoil. Loose ball, strong tackle, breaking the tackle here. Daniel Rioli, good kick down the line. Richmond are coming. Don't worry about that. They are absolutely not out of it. West Coast are trying to make things, invent things that aren't actually there. Bolton's had a bounce on the far wing in the sunshine. He calls for players to come to him. He'll hand pass over the top. They get around to the outside. Dusty, he's been herded up. Shows a bit of it. Got to be there with it. And players crash and bash. It was Tigers had numbers around the corner. They kick, they snap, they go. Misses to the side. Seth Campbell, that could have created a real tightness in the Eagles fans and the playing group combined. West Coast are stuck on 15-8. The Tigers are 9-9. 98 place, 63. Big Fly Waterman. He says, I'm going to come down there and dominate in the back half as well.
This is good a marking display as we've seen for a very, very long time. He's been awesome. Jake Waterman, inside 50, up on the wing. That was mark number 10.
He's having one heck of a game. Running hot for Ream. Ream accepts nothing less than Australia's best Ream. Rotham's going to come back. He could have gone short to Reed. Instead, he goes with a sort of a floating flower bagger. Waterman goes up for mark 11, doesn't take it. Arching the back nicely. There was Eyhoff taken here by Duggan, I think it was. Kicked with the right boot. Petrocelli gathered it when he probably could have tapped it back. Harley Reid feigned the hand pass. Again, has the audacity to have a bounce. Tries to get around one, get around two. He got taken high and got a free kick. He might do a little bit too much at times, I reckon.
You'd rather that in a player, yeah. Because you can take it away from you, can strip them down. You can't always build it up in a player.
Jinby now has the ball. He got a free kick and advantage was paid. Jinby's kick, long inside, forward 50. No mark, ground ball. Cripps is there. Ralph Smith swats it back. Taken by Hunt, screws it back. Chess is outnumbered here. Bolton got back. Loose ball, taken by Williams. Hand pass, game over, Chesser. His second goal. Oh no. For Imar Insurance, the Shed Imar's loyalty program. Goal umpire's call is a goal. We just want to see where it was touched. Oh dear. So my view is this, I don't want to harp on it. The goal umpire's this review system was goal line. What happens on the goal line? If a field umpire misses touched 5 metres out, that's the field umpire's mistake. It's not for the goal umpire to try and fix their errors. It's a goal. And they brought up the ton. And Chester gets his second goal of his career. Tyre Power, your trusted tyre experts. I'm starting to bore myself. 16-8, 104 to 9963.
I'm in favour of the player review. So in that case, it just gets called a goal. The umpires make their decision. If the player has an issue with it, they will then do a review. So in that case, you know, if they thought it came off the back of Tim Kelly, they would have heard that. Players know. They know what side of the post it goes. They know if it hits the post. And they know when it's touched. That would eliminate so many of these reviews.
Imar Insurance, the Shed, Imar's loyalty program for tradies. So the Eagles are going to win. It's now about percentage. Yo shows a lot of the footy. Tumbling punt inside 50. Brockman did well to force his way to the front. Jinby hand pass over the top for Brockman. Didn't have enough on the hand pass. Hack forward by McIntosh. He's fresh aired it. Now hand pass back. Kelly off a step. He's quick kick on goal. Kelly, will it pitch and bounce? It will. The Eagles get the stoppage because the ball tickles over the line. Tim Kelly's had one heck of a game. We'll have a throw in. 104 play 63. Paul Hazelby's keeping an eye on all our power player rankings thanks to Red Energy. Switch to Red Energy.
Boats are going to be difficult.
Kevin's Warehouse, 75 points to them.
Jake Waterman up there. Yo's been good. Tim Kelly as well. Harley Reid.
Here's Kelly again. Taken to ground. Petrocelli off a step. Mark didn't get paid because it was touched. Bolton with the left out of the defensive half. Mansell holding the ball. He went the fend off, got tackled. And Jaden Hunt doesn't mind a goal. He gets up flexing the left leg, a new line up for goal. He's better on the run, former demon.
Good courage too there. Not easy, somebody flying at you. Elbows going everywhere, but just stuck the tackle. All he had to do was spill the ball. Been a good recruit for the West Coast Eagles.
Yes.
He'd love this.
He can take things out of a vending machine by reaching up through the hole because he's got long fingers. 55 metres out. Long kick. They need a flyer. Who's Jack Williams is there? Doesn't mark it. Tap through. Darling, fresh edit. Ooh. Pick it. I think the crowd actually wanted the review for that more than anything. The mark's been taken by Bolton in the back pocket. 105 plays 63. They go short to broad. Building a house in Perth. Lost into a great mark earlier. Wide to Miller. Defensive 50. Hand pass over the top. Just get out of it. Duggan's been good with the left. Marrick lost sight of where the ball was. He tackled Broad. Broad goes to ground. No prior. And the ball up 20 metres around Eagles' end of the ground. 16-9-105 to 9-9-63. Eagles going to win their first game for the year. Yo. Through for a minus score. 16-10-106 to 9-9-63. Jake Waterman has been simply superb today. Go through his stats again if you can, Paul.
15 disposals, 14 kicks, 6 goals, 11 marks, 4 tackles, 133 fantasy points.
Kelly's been outstanding as well. He's got players short, steps around one. He's got a feel for it. He got a little bit hungry, did Timmy? Yeah, and there's a few blokes are not looking in his direction. In fact, I thought Jamie Cripps did. Yo just walked away. They're all just getting a piece of the pie right here. It was a little bit selfish. 16-11, 107 to 9-9-63 in this last quarter. The Eagles have had a 1-goal-3. 1-goal-1 for the Tigers, thanks to Tyre Power, your trusted tyre experts. Turnover. Kelly, once bitten, not twice shy. Oh, he gave it to Cripps this time and too much on the kick. Intention was right. Execution, not quite so.
He's tried to make up for a couple today. One to Jack Darling, who wasn't happy with his work. Gave him one. He dropped that and did the same to Jamie Cripps. Just couldn't jump high enough late in the game.
He was by 44. Barris, oh, he landed on his coccyx. That's C-O-C-C-Y-X if you're going to a quiz night. Ball come to the outside. Sonsi was taken high. 47,665 in the crowd. Apart from the little pocket of Richmond fans behind the Nullarbor plain end goals. They come in board again. Dow. Fans didn't think it travelled the required. Sonsi to the top of the square. The foul. Everyone got caught standing still. Barris got caught. There's about 8 blokes in line there. So LaFau's lining up for his 3rd goal. So this is what can only be described as a bit of a glimmer of hope or a bit of a shining light on a pretty tough day for the Tigers.
100%. This kid can play. It's been tough. He's had McGovern. He's had Barras. He is athletic. He's got speed. He's a good size. And most importantly, he reads the ball well. Gets in really good positions. What a find for the Tigers. They can build around him.
Kick 3 goals. 6-2 from set shots. He's still trying to will his team on. 10-9-69. Margin back to 38. 16-11, 107, 17 gone. For the Tyre Power, your trusted tyre experts. Let's go to the boundary because we can. For Spitwater, Tough and Ready, Chris Kofunas, you still with us?
I'm still with you, boys.
Fire up, mate.
Bailey Williams, he's looking like he's about to come onto the ground, the big ruckman. Interesting because he's had a fair stint on the bench for this quarter, just getting ready and rested for next week where he's likely to come up against 2 big ruckmen.
Yeah, Sean Darcy has to play next week, doesn't he? Because I think we saw the downside of Luke Jackson starting to show a bit of fatigue yesterday. He got dominated by the big Ivan Soldo.
I still take a collective view. They dominated the clearance once again. They've beaten Carlton and Port Adelaide hands down in that part of the game. I know they didn't get the win, but we'll see how the two work. I'd love to see Jackson go forward and kick those goals.
Duggan. Oh, broke 3 tackles. Make that 4. Then goes straight down with the left. Inside 50. Darling punched away from him. Ball comes down. Well done by Marrick. Attacks the footy. Can he keep it in? Tap it back to Cripps. They run it over the boundary line. That was good by Liam Duggan. By the skipper. We'll have a throw in 25 metres around. It's a good point that Chris Kofunas makes on the boundary line for Spitwater. High pressure cleaners. Tools, not toys. Tough and ready.
Elliot Yeo, 14 clearances. 14. Tim Kelly, 8. Bailey Williams, 6. Harley Reid, 6.
Oh, counting that as a dumping tackle. That's a terrible decision. And 50. And 50 against Yo for pushing Loston there. That was just, the last bit was frustration from Yo. Didn't think that was a dumping tackle at all. But it didn't need to push Loston down. So you've got to learn from that. That's not going to help anyone's cause. So one of his better moments, Elliot Yeo, even though I did feel it was a tough call. Loskin goes short to the middle. Young. Everyone forward of the ball. A long kick inside 50. Here's Lefau again at the back. Hoff flicks it up. Witherden with the left. Kick was smothered. Pitching ball now. Rioli, that's Morris, has come out of the game after showing some absolute brilliance. Marek, nice pickup in a tight situation. Back to his lookalike, Jimby, a little trading hand passes. Petrocelli, Eagles have been good in tight. Down the line, Chesser, that's a good kick. Waterman marks, long way from goal. 16-11, 107, 10-9, 69. Chip over the top, down the line. Harley Reid will be the flyer. They love him.
There's a nomination coming his way this week. It wasn't last week. He was beaten by Darcy.
And rightfully so. Darcy was outstanding. But he'll get it this week. Don't worry about that. Inside 50. No mark taken. Right on the 50-metre line. 107 plays 69. Eagles by 38 and jump two spots. No mark to McIntosh. Now, what's happened? He's out of bounds, I think. So the mark wasn't paid. And he stepped over the line. So we'll have a throw in at left half forward for the Eagles. 16-11, 107 to 10-9, 69. It'll be a short review after the team song for MEGT Australia's Apprenticeship Experts. Hazelby will give us all his post-game analysis. We won't have time to get down into the rooms while Tommy Eagles get off the ground. Oh, he didn't know he was coming. Daniel Rioli did really well, though. He went through a Harley Reid tackle. Gave a little 1-2 back and they kick the ball down the line. Duggan clears the pack. Bolton marks on his chest. Into the pocket. Kaczynski arriving. Mark, yes, it's been paid. And he marks on the boundary line. So the live ladder, the Eagles' percentage, 64.7. Richmond's is back up to 79.6. So the Eagles have jumped two spots. Hawthorn are now 17th and 18th, the two winless teams in the competition. So the Eagles are going to win their first game. Close to the man on the mark, Kaczynski. West Coast have got to get numbers. McGovern got pushed out. There's no mark taken on the line. Lefau got into the back of McGovern. We're going to have a ball up in the centre circle as Cripps comes off the ground. Jaden Hunt comes on. Ball up. Tigers centre square, goal square. Bolton and Jack Williams. And Jack Williams again. He's shown a bit. Jack Williams. Been okay. A little foil for brother Bailey. No relation. .47.665 in the house to see the Eagles win. Harley Reid again. Give him the Rising Star nomination and give him the award right now. He's the best player. Don't worry about that. What we've seen today. Pickett left it behind, he hatched it. Umpire pays advantage. Jinby, Witherden, they run for him out wide, long. He's got Yeo waiting for him. Yeo demands the footy. Chips down the line to Witherden, who's run on from halfback. 16-11, 107 to 10-9, 69. Witherden goes short again to Waterman. Easiest mark he'll take today. Long kick, inside 50. Broad gets back uncontested. Pretty poor by Waterman, the kick. He's had a big day. Pickett marks it across his own goal face. 23 gone last quarter. Thanks to Tyre Power, your trusted tyre experts. Don't forget. He's thrown a bit of the footy. Barris has arrived in time to thump the ball over the line and out of play. Is there one more certain goal to come? Thanks to DLFC, certainty through service, delivering certainty through science, innovative forages for farmers, DLF Seeds. Just a nice, easy set shot from the goal square as Dusty Martin hobbles his way back onto Optus Stadium.
Is he fit?
It doesn't look well. I don't know. I haven't read anything or aware of it, but it certainly doesn't look like he's... Well, they didn't get anything out of him today. Virtually non-existent. Yeo, hand pass. Petrocelli closing... Too easy, the pitch has missed. 16-12, 108. 10-9, 69, 39 points the margin. AFL Nation, Tyre Power, your trusted tyre experts. Don't forget our post-game. We have the Eagles song, thanks to Tobin Brothers Funerals, celebrating lives every day of the year. Duggan's been very good today. Skipper. Botham back to Duggan.
It's the first time in a long time they haven't had to do too much, have they? Duggan, Barras, McGovern. The game's been played in their forward half. And you've got midfielders on top. It makes a difference.
Wasn't that way early. It was pretty embarrassing early. The Tigers had four goals, two from turnovers. And from that point onwards, the West Coast Eagles have completely dominated this game. Daniel Rioli again. Baker. Dow. Baker with the left. Comes wide. Seth Campbell just gets away from Jaden Hunt. Down the line, Kaczynski drops the mark. Well done by McGovern. Coles had some moments early. Hunt, his golfing partner, kicks it down the line. Travelled short. Taken by Baker. Hand pass off from Dusty now to Daniel Rioli. Spearing pass in. Good kick and mark out in front of the eyes. And that is hard to defend. Alex Witherden's not happy, but not much you can do about that. As Lafau has taken the mark and he'll line up for goal 35 out. And this will be a good day's work. He's lining up for his...
Did you see that lead? Let the kicker, slight angle, full pace, out in front, no fumble.
Lining up for his fourth goal. So Bolton's got three. Career high. It's a beautiful kick. He's missed. 10-10, 70. 16-12, 108. Duggan comes. Ooh, floating flower bagger. Yeah, it's a hold. Vosten against Yo. Yo saying he punched it, but it was the holding before that, I would imagine. So Adam Simpson gets the win. Of course, Derby here next week. Inside 50. Punched down by the Eagles. McGovern had it, lost it. Dusty went to fend off. There was actually no one there to fend off. And then he ran over the line with the footy. Another throw in, about 15 around.
He's lost the fend-off battle today against Harley Reid.
Harley was very busy.
Harley up to 25 disposals, 7 clearance, 472 metres gained.
Free kick. Going to go against Dan Curvis. Bailey Williams will get the free. So Paul Hazelby will come up with all of his post-game awards. In particular, his 3-2-1. The AFL Nation Player of the Year for the TR Group. Harley Reid takes them on. He runs past the man on the mark. Kicks to the wing. Oh, well done by Broad. A very good mark on the wing. So West Coast by 38 points. It hasn't been a great last quarter inside the final minute of play. Big day for West Coast. Their waffle team won their first game in 28. They're out here, West Coast. Chesser, he's got Cripps. Cripps should just mark and go. Close on 50. Darling straightens up. Cripps says, I don't need you. He goes across the face. So Cripps shouldn't get angry at too many for not kicking at the end, because he had Darling and Marrick inside. A little bit one-sided. Waterman got taken behind the play. And he's slow to get up too, Waterman. That's not good. McIntosh after the ball flipped out to Chesser.
You don't want him ruled out, do you, of next week's derby?
Certainly don't. It comes down the line to Lafau. Shielding his eyes from the sun, Dusty. And McGovern got across. And Dusty ran the ball over the line. West Coast Eagles percentage is 65. They've improved themselves by 15% today. Hawthorne and North Melbourne below them on the ladder. Jake Waterman looks okay. 6 goals, 2, 8 contested marks. McGovern hand passes through. Reid again. Hoff taken to ground, no prior. Steve.
Eagles lift themselves off the bottom of the ladder and hand the spoon to the Hawks and the Roos. Home by 39 points over the Tigers.
Born is pride from isolation, a fortress built. We cross the nation, our colors share.
Six, Yo 2, Petrocelli 2, Jamie Cripps 2, singles to Jack Williams, Harley Reid, Jack Darling, Campbell Chesser, and for the Tigers, Lafau 3, Bolton 3, and singles to Sonsi, Morris Rioli, Dusty Martin, and Liam Baker. 16-13, 109 to 10-10, 70. Celebrations for Tobin Brother Funeral, celebrating lives every day of the year. Paul Hazelby.
Tigers come to play, didn't they, in the first 10 to 15 minutes. They put on four goals. The West Coast Eagles were stunned. The crowd was stunned. And all of a sudden, you thought the story was about Adam Simpson and the West Coast Eagles. But they got those three late goals that were important in the first quarter just to steady the ship. And then that second quarter, amazing. Eight goals and a dominant performance led by their senior players through the midfield. Kelly was terrific. Elliot Yeo was amazing. But up forward, they had some options, and they had some tall options that were very, very good. Jack Darling tried hard, and also Jake Waterman, of course, finishing with the six goals. He was outstanding all day. Tough for the Tigers. It was always going to be difficult. Emotional loss last week, but they've just got too many big guns out of the side. They gave some opportunity to some younger players. They'll learn from that. But the story today, more about the West Coast Eagles, who, on the back of last week, have put together two pretty good performances. So perhaps starting to make some inroads. Harley Reid, youngster for the West Coast Eagles, 27 disposals he had, which was a good sign. His best game in the AFL so far.
All righty, we'll get through your awards in a moment. West Coast win, lift a couple of spots off. Derby next week. Let's flip it around. We know Richmond missed Taranto with that fractured arm from training on Friday. No Bolter. No Lynch. Where are they at?
Well, they're in a rebuild. We know that. New coach was always going to be difficult. He's trying a few different things. And for the most part, they've had a pretty good start to the season. They're now getting some exposure to some younger players. But when you couple that with, you know, a lot of senior players, Cochin, Rewalt, retiring in recent times, they potentially just don't have the depth there at the moment. And to cover Bolter and Lynch, Hopper, Taranto, Prestia, Ross, Gibkus, Grimes, it's a pretty good list. And two travels in a row for the Tigers. They wouldn't do that too often. But it's going to be a tough year for them, you'd have to think, from this point forward, given all the injuries. And a chance for him to develop some of those players that will next build, or hopefully the successful period for the Tigers.
All righty, Paul. Forever Young Player of the Year. So this is a player over 30 years of age. How did they go today?
Elliot Yeo, he is over 30, and he was absolutely outstanding today for the West Coast Eagles. In that second quarter, he was the player that set them alight. He had the 15 clearances to go with 27 disposals and got forward and kicked the two goals as well. It's as good a game as you're going to hope for. All bases covered. He was terrific and made a really good partnership with Tim Kelly and also Harley Reid.
Tobin Brothers Funeral, celebrating lives every day of the year. Who ran the most Ks? Kick back and relax with an adjustable bed from the Australian designed and owned OMF.
Close this battle. It was Seth Campbell with about 2 minutes to go, but Hugo Ralph-Smith got past him, 14.3. Campbell, 14.2. And Jake Waterman came third, 14.1. He was everywhere.
Australian made smart play. It's important to buy Australian right now.
Oh, I just want to recognise Jake Waterman for the marking capability today, where his hands were really strong, but his positioning and not giving away too early to his defender where the ball was going to land. He picked it up quickly, held his opponent about four or five times, and then made a late ditch to get to that position, and with the strong hands, it's a great learning curve for many youngsters out there that want to improve that part of their game. It's about the ball flight, and it's about recognising where the ball's going to land and then protecting that zone.
Support Aussie made products. And one thing, Harley Reid, I don't know how long he'll do this for, but he's gone to the furthest part of the ground to hand over a footy to the fence after his first win in West Coast Eagles colours. Support Aussie made products. The toughest of the day for hard yakka workwear since 1930. Nothing's tougher.
I settled on Jack Darling today for his work. I know he got the trademark award last week for the West Coast Eagles, which surprised me, but he was just as good. And early on in the game too, he started well, he died out a little bit, had his chances, but got to contest, forced the ball to ground, and just got into some good positions. It was the Jack's movement of yesteryear.
Hard yakka, nothing's tougher. The unmissable moment for Drink Wise. You won't miss a moment if you drink wise, choose to drink wise.
Well, I did have a big focus on Bolton, and he didn't disappoint. He was pretty good, Bolton. He just didn't have enough teammates to really help him through that. He kicked the three goals, got them all early, ended up with the 21 disposals. Nothing real flashy from a goal point of view, neither a marking point of view, but he's a star of, well, he's a star right now. He's one of the most watchable players in the competition.
Remember too that Jake Waterman this time last year was in a bad way. His health wise, there was some real concern whether he would play on, and he deals with that. He wasn't happy with the club. His dad wasn't happy with the club.
Yep.
It's been a big 12 months, and it's working a treat for him now, and it's so good to see him get some reward for resilience.
They reckon they knew as soon as he rocked up the pre-season he was ready to have a big year. He's trained hard. And he gets reward today. Like, he gets the 6. So he goes to 12 goals. So he's now up there with all those great players in the competition. I thought he was almost their best player, along with Elliot Yeo and Jeremy McGovern in the early part of the season.
Yeah, he did.
But he just wasn't hitting the scoreboard and getting the big bags. He gets it today. But it wasn't just about the goals. It was the marks as well.
Bendix Brakes, big moment. Put your foot down with confidence. Bendix Brakes.
Well, we had some big marks today. I reckon we saw Mark of the Year. Nick Vlosten, his mark early in the game, and also Bailey Williams on the far side. A pretty good performance by him as well. So look for them. If you haven't seen them, go and check them out. Both brilliant.
Don't forget the Eagles inaugural team who played against Richmond are all here, the original squad. So they were the guard of honour, and they're all down in the room. So you never know, that might have provided some inspiration. All righty, here we go. Your votes for AFL Nation Player of the Year for the TR Group, Commercial Truck and Trailer Rentals and Lease.
One vote I gave to Tim Kelly from the West Coast Eagles. 29 disposals. He had the 6 tackles. He had 8 clearances. 553 metres gained. I put the onus on him and Jack Darling at the start of the game, and he delivered, getting the one vote. 2 votes I gave to his other midfield sidekick in Elliot Yeo. 27 disposals, 15 clearances, 2 goals, 3 tackles from him. Only 363, but he got the work done on the inside. But 3 votes goes to Jake Waterman for his performance. Kicked the 6 goals, had the 13 marks in the contest, and many of them were contested marks. 18 disposals to go with that. Just did everything. 4 tackles and also ran the third most amount on the ground. So worked everywhere. Brilliant performance. We've got to reward goal kickers in this day and age. 6 is a big bag, and he set them alight early.
39 points to the West Coast Eagles TR Group, Truck and Trailer Rentals. Paul, I need some stats, some overall stats, just some of the individual stats and some of the team stats that jumped off the page for you throughout the afternoon.
Well, Tim Kelly, 29. Elliot Yeo, 27. Harley Reid, in the end, got up to 27. 25 went to Liam Baker. Vlosten had 23. Liam Duggan continues a good season with 22. Shea Bolton, 21, to go with 3 goals. Daniel Rioli got busy late, 19. Ben Miller, great start, was well beaten on the day by Jake Waterman. He had 19. Waterman had the 18, broad 18 as well. Jack Graham started really well for the Tigers but died out. He got some midfield minutes today but needed a bit more from him with 17. Petrocelli, 16 and the 2 goals. Witherden and McGovern, 15 apiece. Jack Darling had 14, kicked the goal, missed a couple, and that's about all we'll go through.
Harley Reid and Tyler Brockman copped the Gatorade shower. He was reluctant to get in, but they forced his way in. So it was a big win, 39 points. She's still talking. 16-13-109 to 10-10-70. There's no one here, love. Everyone's going home. All righty, the post-game show for Beaumont's bathroom wear sale. So, Paul, Richmond, we talked about them. We talked about West Coast. Is this significant for West Coast? Was that a moment for West Coast, or should we not lose sight of the fact that the opposition just had a bad day and were pretty ordinary?
Still a moment. Still a moment, and there was a good moment last week too. There was half a game of footy against a good side in the Sydney Swans. And to be fair, this year we can see some improvement on what happened last year. There's a bit of system there. There's a forward line structure that worked. But you can't lose sight of the fact that Richmond, after probably quarter time, they lost their way. And there's a lot of young kids. And I think the Eagles kids are probably better than them. And so they should, because West Coast have had some earlier picks in recent times. But it's a big challenge now. The Western Derby now has a bit of spice to it. Two teams, well, one coming off a win. The Dockers, as good as they've been, they've lost their last two. So they'll be hungry to get their fourth win of the season.
They're going to harness the anger and the frustration, Fremantle. I said last night that the West Coast will be their punching bag next week, just for all of that. We saw a bit of West Coast here. West Coast aren't going to roll over next week.
No, particularly through the midfield. Those three players through that midfield got it done, and it just makes a big difference. It took a lot of pressure off their defenders, because they have been playing footy from the back half for a long time. It's not easy to do in modern-day footy. So if you can get it trapped in your front half, get repeat entries like they did, and let your forwards have some one-on-one looks, it makes a big difference. So we're in for one. Probably still be in favour of Fremantle.
Yeah.
But I think it's going to be closer than most people expect.
Here the Derby on AFL Nation. Well done to the boys, to Lee, to Heater, Connor, to Hayes, to me. It's pretty good today.
Good on you, Jimmy. Passionate, as Mr. always. Furness, that's what we love about
the boundary
you.
Line.
Give him a call. Andrew Dillon. Tonight on the way home, and Laura Kane. See what you can do.
I'll try and do that. I bet what I can do. But let me tell you, if you've got any chance of being on an app tomorrow morning for breakfast, I reckon I'll be replaying my comments from about 3 weeks ago. It might be on high rotation. Thanks for your company. The Eagles are home by 39. They're off the bottom of the ladder. Harley Reid will get the rising star tomorrow.